we welcome you in to the Grossinger Motors Arena in Bloomington, Illinois, for some Saturday afternoon hockey. Hi, everybody. I'm Cristiano Simonetta, joined by Mackenzie Bach for the Illini Hockey Pregame Show. We're glad you could join us. Illinois, 3-0 on the season, as you see on your screen right now. Illinois State, 0-5-2 in their first seven games. Last night, we saw five Illini goals from five different goal scorers. Who stood out to you the most?
Joe Nolan, who actually did not score a goal. Two assists on the night, but he was very close to scoring a goal. Would not be surprised if Joe Nolan was to score tonight.
And Joe Nolan, very active as a defenseman in the offensive zone as we see the benches start to get a little bit full here as Illinois State and the Illini are set. We're about 7.5 minutes from game time. 5-1, as we mentioned. David Heflin makes 23 saves on 24 shots. Ross Lippick, the backup, was supposed to start tonight. David Heflin's going to go again. Should that be a cause for concern, or do we just think it's maybe an equipment issue? I don't know why Ross can't go. We'll obviously hear from Coach Nick Fabrini after the game.
For me, it's a bit of cause for concern. Ross Lippick, the backup, he was completely fine yesterday and should have gotten the start today. But Heflin is back in, and it's a little concerned because you're worried that Heflin might be getting overworked. Now, am I correct?
No, absolutely. As we saw with last year, senior goaltender Joel, and he got injured a pair of times because he started so many consecutive games against great opponents. Now we look at ISU, a team that Illinois handled very well. They haven't won a game all year. You don't want to stress out your starting goaltender. Jake Barnhart, who has not played against ACHA D1 opponents, is suiting up to back up him if anything happens to Heflin. But you got to think that number 29 is locked and ready to go, or else he wouldn't be starting tonight over Ross.
No, absolutely. And like you said, Jake Barnhart, he's fresh. If anything, tonight is the night for him to start in his first ACHA official game.
And we saw Ross, he shut out Michigan State last week. David Heflin had a solid outing yesterday. Now let's move to the offense, though. James McGing, Bobby Ernsting, David Counter. That second line was as tough as any to defend. Eric Cruikshank, Grant Stube, they combined for a goal as well. But how about Tyler Opilka? A goal in every single game that he's played so far. How good has number 22 been?
Least expected from him. A goal in every single game this far. The kid's been doing great, especially last night. His goals have not come easy. Last night, his goal from the top of the left faceoff circle, complete snipe over the left shoulder of Mark Hayton.
And Mark Hayton played really well. The Illini had 50 shots on goal. He has
did.
45 saves. Should we expect a similar attack from Illinois, just getting pucks on net? Because that's their MO, and they like to do that, but only if they're opportune chances. They don't want to waste any shots in the offensive zone.
I think tonight there's going to be less shots on goal for the Illini, and that's with the hope that they will be passing the puck around more and creating more genuine opportunities as opposed to just throwing the puck at the net when there's nothing there.
They were 1-for-4 on the power play last night, the Illini were, but what stood out to me was their penalty kill. They killed off all four of the minors they took against Illinois State. They have a 94.3 PK percentage. We saw it last year drop down to 70%. What has been the difference? Has it been guys like John Moskva clearing the puck out, or Joey Rittendale leading by example, or maybe both of those type of efforts along the 50-50 battles, like the boards, or stuff such as David Heflin being the best player on the ice?
Well, I think it's all of that combined, the 50-50 battles, which you mentioned earlier or yesterday, that we haven't been practicing, but somehow our team has been able to win them for the majority of the time. That, along with our defensemen and our freshmen. Our freshmen have been phenomenal, and it's hard to believe our team last year didn't have those guys, and this year they came right on board, and now they're some of the biggest players we have right now.
And you mentioned the freshman emergence. Six or seven freshmen we see in the lineup each and every night. But we also lost Luke Forfar. You also lose Tommy Abrams. Two players that really can produce. Also, Eric Salter's graduated. But the offense seems to keep ticking. How do you compare this Illini offense to last year?
I think...
I know it's only three games, so you don't want to jump the hurdle a little too bit.
Right. It's almost like nothing's changed. There is still chemistry, especially with the freshmen who are newly acclimated to the system. So it's very surprising, very shocking, but it's a very good sign for the Illini.
And the starters for the Illini, as you see at the top of your screen, Joey Rittendale, number 2. On defense, the senior captain, Joe Nolan, number 27 in orange and gray. Then that second line, Bobby Ernsting centering it, James McGing on the left wing, and then David Kellner on the right wing. We talked to David Kellner in the hotel. He was having a lot of jump to his game. He's very happy with its performance so far. No goals yet on the season. Should we expect that to change right now?
Oh, absolutely. I sure hope so. I mean, the guy's been putting in the work, and he's been setting up the best opportunities, especially last night. You know, we talk about James McGing. We talk about Bobby Ernsting all the time. I want to start talking about David Kellner. This guy deserves it.
David Kellner, no goals so far, has a trifecta of assists. Speaking of guys with no goals that have been playing well, Chance Holmgren as well. And he set up John Moskaluk in the past two consecutive games. Passes where the goaltender thinks he's going to shoot, he dishes it across, and then it's just a tap-in for number 17, John Moskaluk. So the third line with Stephen Quinn is also humming as well. They've got a three-headed monster up front.
And like you said earlier, there's no concern by Coach Fabrini on what line he puts in, because he knows that every single line is going to produce. And not only that, but every line is phenomenal defensively as well. So, I mean, there's really no worries for Coach Fabrini, which is awesome.
Could this be a worry for Illinois State head coach Bobby DiNardi? He sits Mark Hayton in goal. It'll be number 31, Joey Garoppolo, 0-1 on the season. A goals against average of 4, but that save percentage, .907. So no matter if he allows a lot of goals, DiNardi's got to trust his goaltenders to keep 90% of the shots out of the net. That's still a pretty good percentage.
Absolutely. That's a phenomenal percentage. In the NHL, you see a percentage like that, that is a starting goalie. You know, we'll see what happens tonight. No worries. No worries for them right now.
No worries, no matter if it's Mark Hayton, no matter if it's number 31, Joey Garoppolo. How about at the other end, David Heflin? He makes the start. 2-0 on the season, 1 goals against average. How about this save percentage, though? .959.
Phenomenal. Heflin is a brick wall.
He just seems so composed. He seems so technical. It's his last year. They're already talking about national championship hopes. Is it a little too early for that, or do you think it's just the perfect timing 3 games in?
I think it's the perfect timing. You got to get amped up. You got to keep that goal in your mind and remember why you want it. You've got to win every single game. You got to get there. And like you said, this is Heflin's senior year.
All right, thanks, Mackenzie Bach. We're going to send it down to ice level for the national anthem before today's game. And we are just moments away from a Saturday matinee of hockey. 3-0 Illinois on the season. If you're just joining us, hi everybody. Cristiano Simonetta with you. Mackenzie Bach alongside me. We'll hear from Eric Fisher and Abby Kelsto for the intermission reports. Illinois off to a fantastic start to the year. It's basically a polarizing parallel. We've got a team that hasn't won a game all year, and you have a team that's undefeated. Something's got to give, right?
You'd think so. I mean, but like you said earlier, with the strength in lines that Illinois has, it's sort of hard to think that any point on this team will give. And you look at the Illinois State Redbirds, who have been having trouble with the most simplest of fundamentals, including puck control. And you wonder how they're going to be able to get past that and if they will be able to.
Starting for Illinois State, though, on the back end, you got Nate Kuda. He draws in the lineup, did not play last night on left defense. 5 games played this season, no points. We expect the left-handed blue liner to get some time here as we are just seconds away. Saturday afternoon hockey here at the Grossinger Motors Arena in Bloomington, Illinois, and we are underway. Crosley Duckman at the neutral line, number 92 in black, white, and red. Brings it over to Kuda now at the red line. He dumps it in. David Heflin out to play it. Senior goaltender drops it in behind. Now here's Joe Nolan. Sets one up for Kellner, who tosses one ahead for McGing. McGing gains a line near side. Trapped by a pair of Redbirds. Now it's along the corner. Number 17, Jacob Ambersat. On the half board, you've got a battle. Ernsting now for Rittendale. Rittendale kept it in. This could be a break, though, for Illinois State. Jacob Amerset down the left circle. He's got a lot of speed. Moving in, he fires off the left toe. Rebound. Kuda couldn't get to it. An active stick there by the Illini back-checking. Almost the home team getting on the board there. Is now here's McGing at the other side. Left circle, shot one. Wide to Garoppolo as that deflected. James McGing, one hand on his stick. 46 seconds gone by in this first period. No score so far. Kuda along the far side, rings one in around, trying to get it out. Opilka keeps it the right circle. He'll go cross corner as his teammates were changing. Kuda pressured by Eric Cruikshank on his first shift of the game. And now here's Cruikshank forcing a turnover. Here's Drew Richter. Richter out in front and was hoping for James McGing, who's late on his shift. Illinois State dodging an early charge here from Illinois. Keeping the puck in, though, at the end boards is Richter. Richter out in front for Cruikshank, and he scores! Oh, that eluded Joey Garoppolo, as that was an excellent pass from Drew Richter. Eric Cruikshank cashes in a minute 16 into the first.
Biggest thing I saw there was passing, and I love to see that by the Illini. They definitely took their mistakes and faults from yesterday's game, and they're definitely correcting them.
And that's the second time we've seen Drew Richter make that pass. We saw it on Saturday against Michigan State. He went around the net. You think he's going to go completely around the net? Instead, he shovels it near side. Cruikshank goes five-hole on Garoppolo. Not a good start for him in his first start of the weekend. Back underway here, Grossinger Motors Arena. Eric Cruikshank's goal, a minute 16 in. As Stephen Quinn checks a man, that was number 21, Max Pushcheck. Out to center ice, Illinois State clears it in. Heflin sticks it down. Here's Opilka, Effingham, Illinois native. Now back for Joey Caprio. Good to see him in the lineup as he's nursing an injury, a lower body one. And Stephen Quinn tries to gain the line, checked off by number 44. That was Robert Collada. Illinois keeps the puck. Homer in behind the net, and they're going to blow the whistle there. The puck was kept on the outer cage. 18-11 left in the first period. A road team coming in, scoring first again. How good does that have to be for the confidence level on the bench of the orange and gray?
Well, it's a lot better than yesterday's game, where it took them all the way until the last minute of the first period to score their first goal. Total reversal here as they scored it within the first minute of this game.
Illinois State wins a draw in their own zone. Knocked ahead by Trevor Hansen. First of the puck is going to be number 10. That's Connor Bassasi. Bassasi tried to toss one in between the circles. Couldn't do it. Stephen Quinn couldn't handle the pass from Chance Holmer. And Illinois State back to take. It's Mike Cavanaugh. Cavanaugh, two-line pass now for Hansen. Hansen gaining the line, tosses one in. As that's Jack Graham, and a shot there from Bassasi almost eluded Heflin. As that hit off his right pad and steered wide. Illinois State clears it back in. Bassasi against Kindati in the skates of Graham, and now a backhanded try there as that one's off the cage, as that was number 71. Mika Young back to the point for Addy. Gloved down by Heflin. Just another day at the office for the goaltender. 2 minutes and 29 seconds into the first period. 1-0 visitors.
No traffic in front of the net there, which made the save very easy for Hef.
Yeah, Dan Addy, we know he can really let it rip, but if there's no traffic in front, all the goalie's got to do is make sure he gets his body in front of it to knock it down. Heflin did so there. Face off at the near side of the Illini zone. Now it's Grant Stuve. Stuve playing it for Richter. Richter, one hand on his stick, taps one ahead. Mika Young to take. Young, the Tawanda, Illinois native, lost the puck, and now it's right out in front for Stuve. He shows a great save by Garoppolo. The goaltender's down, and the puck stays out. Garoppolo, a nice bounce back there. Now at the right point, Rittendale shoots one wide of the blocker of Garoppolo. Joe Nolan lassos one to the near side. Now here's Stuve twisting and turning one on net. Mika Young stopped that one. And Richter and Young battle along the near side corner in the Redbird zone. 16:55 left in this first period. Here's Cruikshank. Back to the line for Rittendale. Rittendale cleared one in. Nice route jump by Young as Young trying to spring his man. That was number 11, Ryan Glennon. I don't think any relation to Mike Glennon. I don't know if you'd want to be related
sure
to him at this
so.
Point. As now it's back in the Illini zone. Here's Joe Nolan. Nolan, smooth skating right-handed defenseman. Backhands one in. As that was suppressed, though, trying to catch the Illini on the change. As that pass went through the skates of number 81, Joe Pirelli, who had a great game last night. No stats for it, though. One hand on his stick. Now here's Stuve. Stuve digging between two Redbirds. Gets it in deep. Now along the center line, it's number 19. That's Adam Howie. Howie can only get it as far as the Illini near side corner, where Opilka brings it back to center. Now it's Matt Mullally for Crosley Duckman. Just 4 minutes into this hockey game, Illinois already has a lead, thanks to the goal scored by Eric Cruikshank. Nice steal there from Andrew Wicklund. Fourth line out for Nick Fabrini's club right now. And now here's a shot from Novosel. That's another stop. And a secondary effort from the former Redbird Evan Sabo is also defused by Garoppolo. So after that first goal, number 31 in black, red, and white, has settled in here. A big response, as if he lets in another goal, this could be a rout early.
Yeah, and again, Illinois State, you see them making more mistakes with puck control. They're just not maintaining the puck. And if they continue with that, you know, they're just going to keep allowing Illinois to continue generating more chances.
And there's a turnover as Wicklund was the beneficiary of that one. He dumps one in below the goal line. Now it's DJ Mussey. Mussey bringing it through his own zone. Nice turning there as he gets it along the red line. And only decision there is to dump it in where it's Joey Caprio. Caprio now for Opilka. Opilka flips one out to center. 4 minutes and 35 seconds gone by in this first period. 1-0 Illinois. We thank you for tuning in on YouTube. Cristiano Simonetta with you right now. Mackenzie Bach alongside me in the beautiful Grossinger Motors Arena. As now here's Ambrosat. His centering feed was intercepted. Now Addy at the line. He shoots one off the outside of the cage. Dan Addy, that seeing eye shot. Whenever you see 77 rip one, you know it's going to be a good chance. Now here's Sabo deking around Addy. And he goes down, but no call, no penalty so far in the first 5 minutes of play. As that saucer pass eluded the stick of Ambrosat, it'll go all the way down. Rittendale hits the hash marks. Shots on goal, 4 for Illinois State. So the home squad much better in that regard after they were outshot at one period of time, 10-1 by Illinois.
Yeah, absolutely. Better, much better ratio, 1-1 ratio as opposed to the 10-1 ratio as we saw yesterday.
Bobby Ernstig on the draw, won it back for James McGing. McGing floating at the high circles, left one for Rittendale. He was pressured a bit. Now Joey Bauer in counter battle for it. And here's Ernsting. Ernsting, backdoor play from McGing, and that was a nice stick there from a Redbird to take away that chance. Below the net now. A nice active stick again from David Counter. He's so good in that regard. And this is number 18, Jeremy Norway, who led Illinois State in points last year with 36. Now on the red line, it's Rittendale. Rittendale back for Nolan, his defensive partner. Joe Nolan almost with a turnover there. Now here's Norway. Hoping to spring the offense, can't do it. This could be a 3-on-2 for the Illini. It's Counter. Counter, now to the middle. Here comes David Counter on his backhand. Wide open chance for Ernsting. He missed just wide of the blocker. Bobby hoping for his second goal of the year. And now here's McGing. McGing attempted to split through three Redbirds. Couldn't do that at the end of their shift, the second line. Creating more chances. This is McGing again. Blind pass, intercepted. And here comes number 10, that's Bisacy. He was stripped of the puck, James McGing. Has it along the right circle. Gains the line. Moving in. Nice backhand. Here comes James King. What a move. What a backdoor pass and a goal. Oh, my goodness. David Counter does it. And it's 2-0 Illinois. 6 minutes and 16 seconds into the first.
There we go. David Counter. We now can finally start talking about this guy. Very happy that he got his goal, first goal of this weekend.
And Eric Fisher mentioning to me, he called that before the game. We also mentioned it at the pregame show. David Counter. But how about that setup from James McGing?
Oh, my gosh.
Unbelievable. 2-0 Illinois. We're glad you can join us here on YouTube.com. Cristiano Simonetta with you. Mackenzie Bach alongside. Back underway here. And a quick chance now for Illinois. It's Mark Condotti at the left circle. Condotti, far side, shoots one on. That one is stopped by Garoppolo. On the far side, it's Mika Young. Young battles with Richter. Puck played below. Illinois State's got to get some jump to their game right now. Here's a toss. Out to center ice. Knocked down by Jack Graham. Graham, the junior, who played his first 2 years at Division II in Illinois, gets a chance with a big league club now. His pass hit off a Crookshank back in Illinois State zone. Glennon redirected the puck with his fellow blade. Now back at neutral ice for number 92, Crosley Duckman. Played in 6 games this year, no points so far. As Illinois State trying to cause a turnover in the Illini zone. Here comes Cruikshank attempting to kick it to himself, can't do it. Again, rung around, Heflin out to play it. Shots apiece, 5-4 in favor of Illinois, 2-0. But now here's Illinois State with a dry, and that one was Mika Young. Cruikshank trying to race after to the neutral zone. Bringing it to his forehand, he's got it, he fires one off an Illinois State player. And the speedy number 22, Anthony Corcoran, on his second shift of the hockey game, he gets a stick in the midsection, and Joey Caprio to touch. Illinois will go to the penalty kill. 7 minutes and 35 seconds into the hockey game, Illinois State a chance to cut the lead in half.
It's a chance, absolutely. But as you mentioned about yesterday, the Illini had a flawless penalty kill. So for Illinois State, they're going to hope to break that today.
Eric Cruikshank in the box. Number 15, the Burlington, Ontario native, sits for two. Illinois State heads to the power play. They set up. It's Corcoran. Corcoran now for Norway. Pass out in front, looking for a backdoor. That didn't come to fruition. Now at the right point, kept in by Corcoran. A pestering Moskaluk trying to get to him. Can't do it. Norway at the left circle. Eric Cruikshank sits for two. 2 minutes for slashing. Drive right there, and that was stopped by Heflin, and here comes Chance Homer. Led the team in shorthanded goals last year. He gains a red line, tosses one to himself, and now it's number 18. And that was Norway, and I believe there's going to be another penalty on the Illini. We'll have a minute 31 of 5-on-3 time. Holmgren's going to go to the box for tripping. As monumental as a time for the home squad to get back in this hockey game. Another 5-on-3.
You hate to see that Holmgren, of all people, to get this penalty. As you just mentioned, led the team in shorthanded goals last year. Not that goals are a problem for the Illini right now, but you definitely want to see them keep it out of their defensive zone.
5-on-3, Illinois State, almost a full 2 minute segment, a minute 31. Illinois just got to win this draw here, but they got one of their best penalty killers, as we alluded to. Holmgren in the box, Cruikshank one of the best faceoff men beside him already. If you're head coach Nick Fabrini, you got to be a little frustrated right now. A 2-0 hockey game, and you allow the home squad to get right back in it, thanks to some disciplinary issues. As we get a lull here in play, Christian Simonetta with you right now. Kenzie Bach alongside me. 2-0 Illinois. Goals from Eric Cruikshank and also David Counter. Good for Counter to get on the scoreboard. James DeGing with that excellent setup that we'll be seeing on SportsCenter tonight, probably.
That was too nice. I definitely want to go back and look at that replay. I don't even know how he was able to work that. How many defenders did he beat?
I think he just beat two. He made the deke at the high slot and then went along the far side and Counter. Garoppolo had no chance on that left circle. If you're watching this game right now, you can go back and you can see how that goal was generated. We'll look at it in the first intermission. As there still is a bit of a discussion as David Kellner skates off. So it'll be Bobby Ernsting, Joey Rittenail, and Joe Nolan. Another freshman on the back end in such a crucial situation. 5-on-3. When you put players out there, you usually want them to be the most responsible and the most hard on the puck so that they can get it out. Number 27's already risen on that depth chart. It's got to be great for his confidence, too.
His experience in the ACHA only goes as far back as 3 games. And Coach Rubini is putting this much trust in him. Phenomenal. Very, phenomenal. And he did this yesterday as well.
And they did. And they killed off the 5-on-3. Here's a chance for Illinois State now, as here's Nolan trying to get the job done, and he does. From one knee, no less. So the Springfield Junior Blues produced a gem of Joe Nolan to bring him to the Illini. Great scouting from head coach Nick Fabrini. Now here's Kyle Melton, who scored the only Redbirds goal last night. Here's Robert Collada, leads the team in goals with 4. Now back to left point for Kyle Melton. Melton skates in. Now across backdoor play. Oh, maybe one too many passes there as number 10. That was Connor Basasi. Might have had an open look. Instead, tried to feed it across. A minute 26 left on the penalty to Holmgren. 50 seconds left on Cruikshanks. Now a drive. That was blocked at the right skater Rittenail. That stung. Now to the right point for Hansen. Trevor Hansen. Very deliberate here on this power play. It's Melton. Back to Hansen. He steps in one. He fires in a save made looking for a rebound try. And Nolan again with 2 men around him. Dumps it 200 feet down the ice.
Giving Illinois State the benefit of the doubt here, they are doing a really great job at creating opportunities.
Big hit by Ernsting on Glennon from Basasi at neutral ice. He's slow to his skates. He'll go off for a change. Still a 5-on-3 for 20 more seconds. Here's Melton looking down low, trying to thread one across. Couldn't do so. At the left point is Jeremy Norway. Norway across for Melton. He fakes the drive. Now across, looking backdoor off of Caprio. Winding shot off the goalpost. Oh, Kyle Melton with a slap shot, and he met iron with that. We'll be back to 5-on-4 there. The biggest opportunity on that power play, and Melton hits the right post. 25 seconds left on Chance Holmgren's minor. 10:17 left in the first period, 2-0 Illinois. Here's Anthony Corcoran. A lot of speed, goes cross corner with it, establishes possession for his club. Now here's Norway, eluding a check. Wafts one to his teammate. That was Bauer, the captain of this team. But instead, it's Joey Caprio coming out with it. He can't backhand it out, though. Kavanaugh, great pass across for Bauer. About to be back at even strength. And Illinois State with one more chance. Back to 5-on-5. Holmgren's out of the box and now in the high slot. Skating along the goal line, it's Norway. Norway on his backhand, pushing one through. Now to the right point, what's going to happen here? Holmgren's going to take the puck, and Illinois may have a 3-on-2. Holmgren gains a line. Now here's Ernsting across for Opilka. Or excuse me, that was McGing who set him up. That puck is thrown all the way across for Ambersat. Rittendale with a baseball batted attempt. Knocks it for his club. And shots in the game. Illinois State 6, the Illini 5. Here's McGing going over neutral ice. Maneuvering through a couple. He'll take a man wide. And clear it in across. Here's Wicklund. Andrew Wicklund, senior forward, had one goal last year. He's hit hard by Dan Addy, who has been an annihilator of Illini players this weekend. Illinois keeps the puck, though. Here's a spinning chance there from Novacell and a stop from Joey Garoppolo.
Wasn't sure where that puck was at for a second there.
And it's right underneath him in the blue paint, but he makes the stop 10 minutes, 57 seconds into the first period. 2-0 visitors.
You know, I like what Andrew Wicklund was trying to do right there. I'm trying to go back behind the goal with the puck, but unfortunately two Redbird defenders found him and made him regret that decision.
It's tough when Dan Addy, that 220-pound frame of his, goes in. Now a pass in front for Jack Graham, and he was trying for his first goal at ACHA D1. He instead lays it in behind for Wicklund, who's boarded by a pair. Man, is he getting beat up this shift. Now here's Novacell. Plays one back to left point for Mark Condotti, the man they call Candy. Plays it across for Graham. Now down low for Sabo. Sabo leaves it for Wicklund. Wicklund out in front, and that's a goal! Neil Novacell, his first as a member of the ACHA Division I Illini, 3-0. 8:39 left in the first period. The fourth line gets it done.
You know, fantastic for Neil Novacell, who all yesterday was being the agitator for the team. He was putting in, you know, all the work against the boards. Finally, he got a puck into the net. Really all-around player right here.
And all five guys on the ice generated that opportunity. You have Sabo in behind, Wicklund with a nice pass, Jack Graham and Condotti engaging at the points. Illinois is just off and running here. 3 goals on 7 shots against Joey Garoppolo.
In the first period, might I add.
Exactly. We're only 11 minutes and 21 seconds in. Cristiano Simonetta with you right now. Mackenzie Bach alongside at the Grossinger Motors Arena. And now here's a chance for Holmgren. Holmgren now has... went to the left side, couldn't get to him. Now here's John Moskowik. Moskowik, bad angle shot. Banks off the boards, now the left point where it's taken and dumped down by Norway. I believe this will go for icing. It will. Oh, they finally just wave it off. The official had his arm up. Rittendale was deemed to have been able to get to that puck before it reached the goal line. Norway plays it back. Now for number 22, that's Anthony Corcoran. Nolan shoves off a man. Bauer keeps the puck, though, and plays it in head. Number 17 for Illinois State, that's Jacob Ambersat. Ambersat lost the puck as he was tied up. Now here's Nolan, beautifully skating out of his own zone with ease. Now toss it for Stephen Quinn. Quinn's got Moskowik right side, and active stick from Garoppolo there to push that one to the far corner. Ambersat gaining over the neutral ice. Now the blue line for Illinois State. 7:40 left in the first period, 3-0 Illinois. Great play from Collada. Collada goes to his backhand, keeping play alive. Caprio bumps into him. Collada still got it. Collada back to the left point. Watch out for Dan Addy. Gets some space. Fires one. Off a leg in front. Now it's Norway. Ordered to the end boards by Opilka. Now Opilka getting some help from Cruikshank. Cruikshank along the near side corner. 3-0 Illinois. Norway back to the right point. A shot there from Kavanaugh. That was wide. And now it's back along the near side for Moskowik. Moskowik. Nice pass for Quinn, who overskated it. But instead, sautés one up for Eric Cruikshank. He's hungry for a goal. Now goes in behind. He's already got one tonight. Check to the corner there by Mussey. 6:50 left in this first period. 3-0 Illinois. On the road, Illinois trying to improve to 4-0 as Illinois State attempting to get their first win of the season as they're 0-5-2. Connor Bassasi, number 10 in black, white, and red. His pass hit no fellow receiver. It's Graham. Playing on the near side corner, Richter is bumped by Mussey. Bassasi plays it again now for Crosley Duckman. Duckman's pass hit no one. Mark Condotti touches it, no icing there in his own zone. Sophomore defenseman. Plays one up for Stuve, now across for Graham, and now it neutralized. Ernsting with a nice one-handed tip, and here comes Richter. Richter, he fires, looking for that high blocker. Said the ricochet comes from McGing. McGing is boarded, and now here's a chance from Ernsting. He almost got it, but now there's a whistle. And I believe an elbowing call is coming up. Connor Bassasi heads to the penalty box. He got that right elbow up on James McGing, and now Illinois goes to their first power play of the game.
Interesting, because yesterday you saw that knee Was that called?
Yeah, it was a kneeling call. So the referee's really, really strict about that type of contact, whether it's to the head or if you stick your knee out, the two most dangerous plays in hockey.
And now we're seeing the elbow.
The Illini will surely benefit from it, though, on a power play, first of the night. You got McGing, Opilka, Ernsting, Stuve, and Cruikshank. Number 22's got it. Now across the left circle for McGing. Ying left circle, far side, playing it back for Opilka. Opilka for Cruikshank. Reverses it again. Straight away, Opilka fires. That's off a man in front. Corcoran and Stuve are right there. The ricochet comes all the way back to center ice. Opilka drops one back. Now here's McGing. Slowly skating. Illinois State respects his skill. Now back at the far side for Ernsting. Now for McGing. Man cross for Cruikshank. He wanted a one-timer. Fan on the pass back for Opilka. Opilka's got a plan on his backhand. Skates to his forehand, left side. Now for McGing again. A minute 19 left on the Illini power play. Bisacci sits. 2 minutes for elbowing. Back at the point for Opilka. Sets up Cruikshank. Winds one. That's blocked at the left skate by number 11. That was Ryan Glennon. New Lenox, Illinois native, gets in front of that one. Illinois keeps the puck, though. Ernsting back at the left point for Cruikshank. Cruikshank looking for a high slot redirect. Off a stick in front and almost some friendly fire as Corcoran skate. Almost redirected the puck behind his own goaltender. Nice clear from Illinois State. 5 minutes left in the first period. 3-0 Illini. Ernsting will set the play up. One of the many quarterbacks on this power play. He hands it off to another QB. And Tyler Opilka feeds one for Ernsting. Ernsting over the red line, over the blue line. Illinois State backing in here. 35 seconds out of the power play. Nice move from Ernsting. Ernsting, I thought he was going to go for a power move instead. Plays it for Moskaluk at the far side. Here's Drew Richter. Richter down low for Moskaluk. Moskaluk pestered a bit by number 3, Mussey. Drew Richter at the point. Now here's Moskaluk. He's got Nolan right point. He hits him. Nolan moving to the middle, holding the line. Now back for Moskaluk. 15 seconds left. John plays it for Drew. Drew Richter. Joe Nolan looking to shoot it. Instead over to Holmgren. Holmgren's got bodies in front. Off the knee. And instead, Dan Addy tried to clear it away. Couldn't do so, and finally is able to. Illinois State, 1-for-1 on the PK. A great effort from them because if there's a goal from Illinois, they're down 4-0 16 minutes into the hockey game. Here's Joe Nolan, fakes around a man, skates through his own circles, plays it for Moskaluk. He was poked away, but Nolan is there to rescue. And Rittendale's got it at his own blue line. Ladles went ahead for Moskaluk over his stick. There's an icing call as Duckman reaches the hash mark. 16 minutes and 15 seconds into the first period. 3-0 Illini. We want to thank all you fans for tuning in on YouTube for this Saturday matinee edition of Illini Hockey on the road. Cristiano Simonetta with you. Mackenzie Bach alongside. If we were to say there's a standout on Illinois right now throughout this first 16 minutes, who's it got to be?
For the Illini you're talking about? A standout, Joe Nolan. I mean, he's been leading the 5-on-3. He's been leading the power play. He's working all facets here.
And we saw him with a pair of assists last night. Here's Drew Richter, fellow freshman, gaining the line, right circle. Rest of his regime is changing. Richter's got some space, though, and a lot of options. Tried to go through a pair of Redbirds with that pass. Intended for Caprio, instead it's on the stick of Ernsting, who turned the puck over. Trevor Hansen on the read. Great back-checking, though, from Opilka, who steals it away. Illinois on a 3-on-2 rush. Here's Ernsting playing it in front for Kellner, who tried to go to his backhand, but that puck escaped him. Whenever Bobby Ernsting's got the puck, you never know what's going to happen. And now David Kellner on the rush for Illinois. Great pass to the right point for Opilka. He fires. That one's deflected off the blocker of Garoppolo. And now to the catching glove of Ernsting. He fires, and that one was deflected wide. Late period charge from Illinois, already up 3-0. 2:50 left in the first period. McGing maneuvering through two. It was Kuda as well as Hansen. Now back to center. Ying gains the line again. Great pass to Opilka. Opilka right circle. He fires one wide of the blocker. Novacell, who scored the latest Illini goal. Now for Kellner. Kellner looking for help instead. He was checked off the puck. Ryan Glennon to take it. Glennon harassed a bit by Novacell. Keeps the puck. He fires one in. A save made by Heflin. An awkward save and a second shot. That stopped. Number 29 in orange and gray with a bit of a blunder, but he's able to make up with the rebound stop. He's been great, 17-36 in this first period, 3-0 Illini.
And Novacell, as you mentioned just now, almost had his stick come out and whip around and hit.
That was almost a slashing call with Glennon going through the middle of the ice. The refs, very strict, as they should be.
Absolutely. You
never want to see swinging lumber by any means. Those sticks do not have any give. Does not feel good to be hit with one of those.
No chance.
Jack Graham Playing it for Andrew Wicklund at the near side halfboards of the Illini zone. Now out for Novacell. Novacell, who's looked sharp in the two games this weekend. Him and Evan Sabo on the fourth line. Now along the far side in the Illinois State zone. Push check, has it. Regains for Corcoran. Corcoran played the puck a little bit too in front of him. But is able to whack one into the neutral ice. Sabo with the steal. Now here's Novacell. He's held a bit by number 21, push check. Turnover here. Here's Wicklund. Wicklund out in front. Oh, he had Evan Sabo, the former Redbird. How great would that have been for the former ISU student and athlete to score against his former mates? Now a backdoor pass at the other end. That was number 17. Ambersett trying to benefit. Can't do so. A lot of back checking from Illinois. Two-way hockey. What head coach Nick Fabrini wants to see. But for fellow bench boss Bobby DiNardi of Illinois State, you got to get a goal before this period ends. Even though there's so much time left in the hockey game, a tally with maybe half a minute to go would really revitalize the crowd as well as his team's momentum. Well,
absolutely, and the three-goal lead is the worst lead for any team that's on the other end of it.
Exactly. Worst lead in hockey. Here's Joey Rindale attempting to add to it. Moskaluk shakes around Mussey, who took a piece of him. Tough to knock the 6'2" forward down. There's an errant pass for Stephen Quinn. Has to wait for his line mate to tag up. That was Holmgren. Less than 60 seconds left. This is an errant pass again. Quinn trying to get to it. Can't do so. Bassasi instead. And some sticks being exchanged from Mussey and Holmgren. The far right of your screen. Nothing doing there as we stay 5-on-5. Moskaluk with it for Quinn. Quinn back to number 17. Moskaluk. That was stolen away and knocked back to center. Third line out for Illinois. This one's going to be offside as Moskaluk collided with Collada. 30.2 seconds left in this first period. Illinois out shooting Illinois State 11-8.
That was too clearly offsides there. Nothing to say there. John Moskaluk was clearly way past the blue line.
Well, you want to know why? Because Illinois State is putting three or four guys at the blue line trying to stand up Illinois' rush attack. So when they bump into
it's something.
Not a penalty. Unless it's an egregious interference call, which that wasn't. That was incidental contact. That could try and obstruct the Illini's attack, in which we've seen Illinois not be able to score a goal for quite some time now, despite the fact that they have three. A chance here for Illinois State. A shot went wide. The stick of push check. Richter. Nice pass for Stube. Stube and Cruikshank trying to get it there. Richter off the steal. Instead, puck changed possession quickly. Graham tried to step up against Young, knocks him to the ice. 6 seconds left in the first period. Corcoran out to center. Illinois couldn't get that last spring attempt, and that's going to conclude this opening frame of hockey. 3-0 Illinois over Illinois State. Early goal from Eric Cruikshank. Neil Novacell gets on the board, and David Kellner gets his first goal of the year. Outstanding period on the road, especially for a team that struggled away from the big pond last year, wouldn't you say?
I just want to congratulate the Illini for finally getting their passing game going, because I think that that is the biggest reason why they are now up 3-0 in this first period, as opposed to yesterday, where it took them the whole, almost all 20 minutes, took them 19 minutes in the first period, so it took them till the last minute to finally get their first goal. Total reversal here as they, getting points on the board.
Yeah, they only scored one goal. Like we mentioned, like you said, in the early parts of this first period, Drew Richter with the only one with 30 seconds left in the first. Now they come in with a three-goal outburst. There's still time for Illinois State, but what's a key for them to get back in this one quickly?
Defense. They can't allow the Illini to continue to hold the puck in their offensive zone. And that is the biggest problem that ISU is having right now, is clearing the puck out of their own zone.
And we'll see if Illinois State can bounce back in the middle frame. You're going to hear the first period intermission report in just a couple minutes. This is Illini Hockey presented by YouTube.
did you stand there all alone? Oh, I cannot explain what's going down. I can see you standing next to me. In and out, somewhere else right now. You sigh, look away. I can see it clear as day. Close your eyes, so afraid. Hide behind that baby face. Do, 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 do. You can drive. Yesterday, as I recall, you were looking out of place, gathering up your things and slipped away. No time at all, I followed you into the hall. Cigarette, daydream, you were only 17, so sweet with the mean.
Reporting live from the Grossinger Motors Arena for the first period intermission, I'm Abby Kelso alongside Eric Fisher, and you're listening to Illini Hockey on YouTube Live. So yesterday we came in, kind of hated on our own team, to be honest, because we were really upset with how they were playing, but what we saw that second period, they came in strong yesterday, and that's pretty much how they continued to play first period today. What do you think, Eric?
Yeah, they definitely didn't come in sweeping on this ISU team on this Saturday game, something they used to do against opponents on the road last year. But they came in on a mission. They came in ready to put this game away, and we saw three beautiful goals, really great offensive sets on each one of them. And ISU just has no answer. They have defensively, they just have no control of what goes on in their own zone. And offensively, they can't get the puck out of their own zone, so that's not even allowing a rush for on their end to occur.
At one point, they had a power play opportunity. Two of our guys were in the box, and they still did not capitalize on that opportunity.
Oh, yeah, well, that's just ridiculous and infuriating for a hockey coach. When you have a 5-on-3 for a minute and 35 seconds and you don't convert, that's just unacceptable. And I'm sure that's what ISU is trying to figure out in their locker room is what exactly happened there. But their passes were not connecting. They were just a step slow, apparently. And Joe Nolan played amazing on that 5-on-3. He really bullied his way in front of the net to try and get that puck and made several great clears.
Yeah, another player that really stood out during that penalty kill for the Illini was Joe Caprio. Once again, this dude flings his body in front of anything and everything to make sure that they can do well.
Yeah, that's great to see. Knowing he has a lower body injury today, he's playing a little banged up. but he's still giving it 100% because he knows how important it is to go undefeated on the road and really take care of business against teams that you are on paper better than.
Right, and Joey Caprio is a senior leader on this team as well as, so yesterday we were really focusing on the senior leadership and how that was kind of setting the stage for everyone else. Can you talk about how that set the stage for today and how we've really seen a bunch of rookies come out and show what they're made of?
Well, it's just leading by example, I feel, right now. You have Eric Cruikshank buries the first goal of the game, the senior leader, even though he doesn't have a letter on his chest. He's always leading by example. If you're a younger guy, that's what you have to love to see from your upperclassmen. And so when you see those guys come out playing 100%, even on a road game where you dominated the day before, that has to motivate you to want to do the same and follow in their footsteps.
What was also really exciting was to see a bunch of younger guys on the second shift for the power play. I thought that was really cool. It was Ernsting, Richter, Moscow, and Homerin at one point. All younger guys, they didn't have a senior on the ice. I thought that was really cool.
Well, yeah, and what's so great is you have great facilitators and Bobby Ernsting and Chance Homerin, who are always looking to find the open guy on these power plays. And then you have guys that are like Moscow, who are just right in front of the net, always in the right place at the right time, and just waiting for a great pass from either Ernsting or Homerin to really bury one in front of the net. And that's just great to see. And when you could have two efficient power play units like that, then that makes it your special teams just even more dangerous.
And I love to see how Bobby Ernsting actually started on the first line today. It just shows that he can be put anywhere and everywhere and kind of assert himself in a great situation.
Yeah, he's just a guy that's really stepped up. He's a guy that's going to be a huge playmaker down the road these next two seasons for the Illini. And he's going to be someone that's going to have a letter on his chest come either next year or the year after that. And he's just going to lead his line, whichever one he's on, because he's a very versatile player. He's just going to lead his line to be one of the most efficient ones on the team.
Yeah, going off of that, Eric Cruikshank scored on the first shot on goal of the game. Going on this kind of positivity track, can you mention a few other kind of standout guys that really led to the fact that we are up 3-0 right now?
Oh, James McGee. I mean, he's the best playmaker on this team, and he just shows it. And for a guy that like him to come out on one of these games where you don't really kind of want to be here, it's a team that you know that you can handle easily, to come out here, play 100%, and motor going all the way, and just continue to make beautiful plays like we saw on the David Kellner goal, where he had that nice backhand toe drag to get past the defenders and feed Kellner for the wide open net. To see him out here playing as hard as he is great to see, and that's something you might have not saw out of James McGee last year or the year before that.
Right, and going off of that, I see people who are usually like more Patrick Kane-esque, you know, just playing a lot of offense and not a lot of defense, playing a lot more like Jonathan Toews, who has a two-way player, great attitude.
Yeah, and James, last year, James McGee, you didn't see him a lot on the penalty kill, but this year, him and Ernsting, another guy that was on the penalty kill a lot last year, they're the guys that are manning the fort right in front of that penalty kill, and they're being extremely active. So when you could have as talented offensive players like that come out and on your penalty kill of special teams and make great plays like that, it's just not fair for other teams.
Well, before we send it back to ice level, can we talk about, first of all, congratulations to Neil Novosel for scoring his first goal of the season and first on this top team for the Illini.
Oh, it's always great to get that chip off your shoulder and bury that first one in the back of the net. And he had a great feed also from that allowed him to bury that as well.
Yeah, also, but there are some things that I'm a little bit concerned about on the ice. They haven't been calling as many things as I would have liked. I saw a very serious holding call earlier, and they didn't say anything. Have you noticed anything else like that?
I just noticed the physicality is back to where it was yesterday. Guys are really hitting each other on the boards. It's not that ISU came out here not to play. It's just that this Illini team is just a step ahead of them. They're in their own zone. They're hitting these Illini as hard as they were yesterday, but they're just not being able to get out and transition as much because the Illini are always a step ahead to keep the puck in the ISU zone.
Right, going off of that, I think the Illini have really come out more aggressive and assertive today. They're hitting a lot more, but in a controlled way, which is something they couldn't do last year. They would hit, but it wasn't controlled. They would kind of let their emotions get out of the way, but we haven't been seeing that at all, even though some people yesterday were trying to provoke James McGing, but not he's not going for it.
No, they're just playing very well-disciplined hockey. That's what you have to love to see.
All right, well, thank you very much for your insight, Eric. I'm Abby Calisto alongside Eric Fisher, Cristiano, and Mackenzie. We'll have the call in just a few moments. This has been your Illini Hockey Intermission Report from the Grossinger Motors Ice Arena.
Back underway for the second period. Hi, everybody. Christian Simonetta with you right now. Eric Fisher joins me alongside 3-0 Illinois of the Illinois State Redbirds. Now here's David Counter, scored in the first period, looking for a backdoor play. That was Robbie Ernstein slinking in. 25 seconds gone by in the second. Shots 11 for Illinois, 8 for Illinois State. Home squad's got to get back in this one quickly, and an early goal in this middle frame would do that. Jacob Ambersett on the right circle, moving, trying to hit the outside of the cage, does so. Plays it to himself. Come back to the left point. That was Corcoran who couldn't keep it in. Heflin comes out to play it. The Redbirds dive back into their own zone. Here's Joe Nolan, who I thought had a splendid opening frame.
Oh, absolutely. He's out there. He's being that fourth forward for this, whichever line he is on. He's leading the rush and making great plays.
Delayed offsides here. Counter has to double back. Illinois State with the puck now. Max Pushchek, excuse me. That's a tongue twister, playing it all the way. Here's Nolan, backhands one across. Not the most eventful first minute 15 of the second period, but hopefully that'll shift as we are going to get an icing call. Opilka hits the hash marks. And Bobby DiNardi, the head coach of Illinois State, obviously frustrated about that one and hopefully trying to get some life into his team. He's showing some emotion on the bench there.
Oh, yeah. He had to be frustrated in that after that first period where they had a minute and 35 of 5-on-3 power play, and they weren't able to convert or let alone even get a quality shot on goal. So that has to be frustrating alone.
Face off to the right, Joey Garoppolo. Eric Cruikshank on the draw, won it back for Drew Richter. Richter on the right circle. Puts one in behind instead. That was jumped by Pushchek. Great stretch pass. Now moving in is Trevor Hansen. Hansen going to get through it, and he can't. It's on the outside of the cage trying to whack at it there, as now it's Collada. So Tyler Opilka neutralizing Hansen's try, as once again those two battle. Hansen behind the net. Caprio hits it with his hand. Mussey with a drive and a save made by Heflin. I don't think he saw it until it was just about to flow through the circles. A minute 48 into the second period, Illinois State with a charge trying to get some offensive momentum. David Heflin, it's tough to do that, though, when he's not giving up any rebounds.
Oh, absolutely. And Tyler Opilka making a huge play to silence that breakaway opportunity. He realized he got beat at his own blue line, but he came up behind, locked up sticks, and allowed for Heflin to make an easy save.
Mika Young won the draw for Kyle Melton. Addy kept it in. Not the right circle. Spinning drive from Young. Can't do it. Young is tripped up by Homer. No call. Here comes Stephen Quinn. Could be a 2-on-1 for the Illini. Quinn left circle. Has a man at the right side. It's Moskowitz. Pass out in front. And that pass was too far. Jack Graham with a wind. That's in front again. Moskowitz couldn't get to it. Number 7, Mike Cavanaugh. It's Illinois State's rescue. But at the line, it's met by Homer, who keeps it in. Now Melton floats one in behind the net. Hits the skate of the official. The Illini are going to like that. But now Mika Young recovers for his club. Spring through the middle, it's Glennon. He's checked off. Jack Graham, Mark Condotti. These two didn't get the most ice time last year. But they're getting an opportunity here early in the season on the first road trip as that shot goes wide off beyond the left post. And E.J. Mussey trying to get it for his club. Can't do it. Toss one all the way back by Condotti. The Illini hope for a change, the long change here in this second period. Christian Simonetta with you. Eric Fisher alongside Grossinger Motors Arena, 3-0 Illinois, 3 minutes into the second period. Nice deke move there from Jack Graham. He gains the line. Now he's got the puck on his stick. Dumps it in. Rattling one around to the far side. It's Duckman. Duckman to the near side for Norway. Norway's boarded a bit by Novosel, number 14 in orange and gray. I believe he's going to get a penalty here. The referee's got his arm up. There was a whistle. I'm actually not sure what the call's going to be. As 16:49 left in the second period, I believe it's going to be a penalty on Novosel for boarding, I believe.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that one. Yesterday he was hitting pretty hard, but all his hits were pretty clean. And I thought he came at him through the side. He didn't get him from behind. So I find that to be an odd boarding call.
Yeah, we'll see what the official public address announcer deems that call. Novosel 2 minutes from a hit from behind.
Ooh.
Now, usually when those are a little bit more egregious, they're called. But nonetheless, Illinois State to their third power play of the game. Norway controls the draw. Back to the right point for Addy. Dan Addy, a trigger man on this power play. Over to the straightaway for Corcoran. Now on the far side for Norway. Anthony Corcoran hoping for Addy. The near side corner of your screen. Pass out in front. Didn't hit an Illini or a Redbird. And Corcoran can't keep the puck in at the far line. Here's Corcoran. Stops and starts. A minute 37 left on the minor to Novosel. 16:23 left in the second period. Illinois disrupts the Redbirds' rush and toss one back down the ice. Your thoughts on this penalty kill right now from Illinois? Not a lot of puck possession for the Redbirds.
No, and I mentioned this in the intermission report, that last year you wouldn't be seeing guys like Ernsting and James McGee on the first penalty kill line. But this year they are, and that has to show the progress they made in the offseason, really developed themselves into solid two-way players.
Here's McGee digging around a man out in front and was hoping for a slap shot from Cruikshank. And yeah, we've seen Eric Cruikshank on ice for penalty kills, but James McGee and Ernsting, not so much. Here's a stretch pass. Nice break by number 27. That was Nolan. And a dump in there from Joey Bauer. And Rittendale says, I'll take that.
Rejected.
And swipes it back. It's cleared all the way down. Looking like Joel Embiid out there.
Oh, man.
Now on the near side corner in the Illinois State Redbird zone. Kalata's got it off a pass from Norway. Puck squirts free for Corcoran, who gains the blue line out the left circle. Corcoran shoots one in. Half a minute left on the Illinois State power play. Now back to the left point. It's Melton. Kyle Melton has Hansen to his right. Feeds it to him. Hansen down low. Now it's Mussey for Hansen again. To Mussey. Along a bad angle. Top of the point for Melton. He fires one. That's blocked, and that stung David Kellner in the midsection. The junior forward treks on, though. Swipes it away and gets it back to neutral ice. What a tough effort there for number 19.
What a play. He takes a puck inside on the thigh, and then he gets back and gets the puck back into his
And now he draws a penalty, pass out in front for Cruikshank, and he's still got it. Heflin's going to go off to the bench. Cruikshank out in front, and that pass eluded counter. So you make one play at one end, and you draw a penalty at the other. The Illini are going to the power play, 5 minutes and 16 seconds into the second period. Trevor Hansen very, very frustrated with that one, as it's a hooking call in the defensive zone, something you don't want to see if you're Bobby DiNardi, the head coach of the Redbirds.
Well, it has to be. It has to be extremely frustrating where on your own power play, you aren't able to get a shot on goal. And the one time you do shoot, it's an easy block for Kellner, and he just goes on the other end and just attacks like that and draws a penalty.
Face off to the left, Garoppolo. Illini win it. Now for Joe Nolan. Nolan out in front, Hobart score! Oh, what a bullet there! Chance Homerin, his first goal of the season. Boy, was he due, and he blasted that past the blocker of Garoppolo. A power play goal, 5:32 into the second period.
Oh, what an offensive set created right there. Right off the faceoff, right down along to the boards. Homerin's wide open in the middle of the ice. He winds up and fires that one right into the back of the net. Beautiful goal.
Oh, my goodness. Garoppolo's got no chance there. That
no
high
chance.
Slot play, and he let one rip. No mistake. The sophomore from Pekin, Illinois, striking 4-0 Illini. DJ Mussey out and spins one all the way down. No icing here as we're back underway at the Grossinger Mortars Arena. I swear I'm going to get it one of these times. I'm saying mortar.
A mortar. Incoming mortar
this
fire.
This is like wartime here. Grossinger Mortars Arena. In Bloomington, Illinois, 4-0 Illinois. Here's Sable, the former Redbird, out in front and was hoping for a streaking Wicklin. The pass was too far in front. Oh, boy. Evan Sable hasn't had the most amount of ice time playing on that fourth line, but, boy, has he been effective. Now the puck squirts out to neutral ice. Joe Nolan. The patience of his demeanor, he never seems like he's under fire even with oncoming forecheckers.
Nope. And Joe Nolan getting an assist on that goal again. He's just always involved on the special teams.
Yeah, he's a point-producing guy, and that's what they brought him to Illinois for, as Garoppolo pokes the puck to the near side corner. Here's Sabo. Now Illinois State trying to outlet. All they can do, though, is Ambersat tosses one through. And Wicklin gets it in deep for the Illini. Shots are 12-10 in favor of Illinois. 8 saves for Joey Garoppolo, but he hasn't had a lot of help defensively. These goals, especially Kellner's, was wide open. And now here's a wide open Ernsting, and he shot that one wide of the blocker. Condotti keeps it in. Angled in behind. And now directed off the boards and out to center. Condotti Springs counter. Nice steal from Joey Bauer, the captain of this Redbirds team. Plays through two men surrounding number 23. And that's played all the way back now. Great play for Illinois, though, to have support with a pair of guys. And here's number 24, Ernsting. Ernsting trying to shimmy. Joe Pirelli, number 81, bringing it back. Illinois State trying to generate some momentum. It's Corcoran. Corcoran fires one, a save made by Heflin. Easy pad stop for the senior goaltender. Now around the back of the cage. Now it's McGing. McGing lofts one ahead. Ernsting battling with a Redbird. David Counter comes out with it. Look at the speed from Counter. Oh, and that was almost a dangerous play as he was cutting across the middle of the ice with his head down. Pirelli races to the puck in the near side corner of the Illini zone. Opilka will meet him. Opilka's pressured by a pair of Redbirds. They go down, and Opilka's the guy skating all the way at the other end. Here's Richter. Richter with a loose puck deke. Now for Tyler Opilka. Opilka now for Cruikshank on the backhand. He scores! Eric Cruikshank, his second goal of the hockey game. He roofs one past Garoppolo. 7 minutes and 57 seconds into the second period. 5-0 Illini.
Beautiful backhand goal by Cruikshank right there to beat Garoppolo top shelf on his block, on his glove side. But the real play was all created by Tyler Opilka. Takes down two guys along the boards in his own zone, brings the puck all the way across the ice, fights through two defenders, and manages to center the puck just right in front of the net so Eric Cruikshank can bury it.
Cruikshank's third goal of the season in four games. He was off to a slow start against Michigan State. Seems to have found his footing here because he had one goal in that weekend. Now he's got two. Hoping for the hat trick. He's out there on the ice again. 5-0 Illini. Cristiano Simonetta with you right now. Eric Fisher alongside. Grossinger Motors Arena in Bloomington, Illinois. A little congested here. A little under the weather. But the Illini are certainly playing like a healthy bunch as Stube lays one in. That one's to the middle area. On the near side. Poked ahead by number 44, Collada. Collada, leading scorer on this Redbirds team. He moves and he fires one. Was hoping to move Heflin from right to left. There's a spinning try off the stick of a Redbird. Now here's Hansen. Stolen by Cruikshank. Senior forward skating through neutral ice. Going to his backhand. Stuve also with him as Opilka was knocked down by number 10. That was Bassesi who exchanges some slashes with him. Hansen at the other end though. Far side, top of your screen. He fires one and that one was stopped and fought off by the left shoulder of Heflin. 11 minutes left in this first period. Second period, here comes John Moskal moving in on breakaway. Moskal, left pad saved by Garoppolo as number 17 was in tight and tried to slip it through the legs. Now it's Holmgren. Holmgren banks one along the near side corner. Out to center ice we go. It's Joe Nolan. Nolan for Moskal. Moskal waits for his team to tag up. That pass was intercepted by Young. Here's Stephen Quinn. He forces a turnover. Quinn with a shot, and that's off the right pad of Garoppolo. As here's Holmgren. Out in front for Moskala. Moskala had the puck knocked away from him. Nolan left to right point. Now here's Rittinelli. Fires one off the blocker. Loose puck. Moving in. A shot there. And that's stopped by Garoppolo. Two saves from the goaltender. Quinn mixing it up with, I believe, that's Kyle Melton. 9 minutes and 34 seconds into the second period. All the action to the left.
Oh, absolutely. ISU just can't get out of their own zone. And it has to start by them tightening their defense. Several of these goals tonight are just because they have no control of what's going on in front of the goal or in center ice.
And now Illinois State's going to go to the penalty box, push check. Illinois, I believe, is going to have five guys. Even though Quinn was in the middle of that scrum, there's only one guy in the box.
Yeah, so it looks like Illinois is going to have another power play opportunity.
Yeah,
and let's see what we have here out of McGing and Opilka right at the top of the key.
Only took him a couple seconds to score that last power play goal for Holmgren as Heflin comes out to play it. Now for McGing. Push check, 2 minutes for cross-checking, living up to his last name. I had to say
You're
that.
You're clever.
Here's McGing. Now for Cruikshank, gaining through the line. All on the right circle. Already two goals tonight. Back at the point. Opilka. Now for McGing. 5-0 Illinois. 90 seconds left on the power play. Bobby Ernsting. Ernsting, one goal so far this season. McGing trying to hit number 24. He's got it. Now back to the right point for Cruikshank. Burlington, Ontario native for Ernsting. They interchange Cruikshank with a drive. That's blocked by Bauer. Bauer, can he get the puck out? Instead of spinning effort from Ernsting, brings it back to neutral ice. Illinois State trying to change personnel here, but here's Stuve. Now for Holmgren. home run for McGing. Look at how the Illini set up on the power play. They got five guys along the line, so many options, no matter if it's wide ice or the shorter ice here. Here's home run, 50 seconds left. Illini power play, 2 minutes for cross-checking, a mass push check. Now here's a shot from Moskaluk, and he scores! Beauty of a shot. He beats Garoppolo over the blocker as well. Another power play goal. 10 minutes and 49 seconds into the second.
We saw the Illini somewhat struggle on the power play last week against MSU, but this week they seem to have everyone in the right positions where they need to be. Moskaluk, perfect position, right in the right slot as the pass was coming through, and he just buries it top shelf against Garoppolo.
His fourth goal of the season in four games. If you told us that that would be his stat line, a rookie, not even playing last year in hockey, coming in. Fantastic start for the sophomore.
For a big guy like himself, too. Those guys are going to be in front of the net, but he's right in the slots, ready to fire it in.
Here's Evan Sabo and the rest of the Illini fourth line. Two power play goals on the last two power plays. 8:53 left in the second period. 6-0 Illini. Here's Sabo. Now for Novosel. He's got a goal tonight. A lot of guys getting their first. You got counter, you got home run. And you have Novosel. And it's not just one guy that's doing this, though, Eric.
Oh, no, it's not. It's several different goal scorers. The only repeat goal scorer we're seeing is Eric Cruikshank tonight. And even then, it's not like he's trying to force anything.
Here's Sabo. Gets a stick up on his former mate. That was push check. Now out to the middle. Joe Pirelli could have a break. Gendati on his backhand. And he shoves him off. So neutralization of plays like that where you think Illinois State's going to get an odd man attack. The Illini's back checking either a defenseman or a forward. He's able to push them away.
Yeah, Candotti right there just saying, hey, I'm bigger than you, give me the puck. And that's exactly what he did. He buried his shoulder into him, was able to get the puck along the board and just clear it.
6'2", 185 pounds. No points on the year for the sophomore out of Hoffman Estates. He has a big role, though, right now, as we know that Joey Caprio is nursing a lower body injury. Shot there from Duckman, tipped on, save made, rebound try, and a chance from Bauer. Skipped along the end boards. Another penalty coming up. I believe it's going to be Candotti with a high stick, and he's upset about it. 11 minutes, 58 seconds into the second period. Illinois State to their first power play of the period, or maybe their second.
What a series of beautiful saves by David Heflin there. First, he makes the right pad save, and it bounces right back in front of him. Bouncing puck, the shot goes up, and he just gets a little piece of it with his glove and was able to deflect it right behind the net to keep ISU off the board.
And that was Joey Bauer right in his kitchen. So number 97, senior. Trying for a spark, the 6-0 game, I know, but there's still a lot of hockey to be played, 28 minutes. Now it's a power play for Illinois State. Spinning off a man, it's Kuda. Kuda across. Far side, now for Dan Addy. He fires one, save made by Heflin. It's in his paraphernalia. He stops it. No rebound, though. 10 seconds into the power play, 7:52 left in the second.
And that's something David Heflin's always been great at, is his rebound control and his vision. He had perfect vision of where that puck was going to go. He knew it wasn't going to get deflected much off of anyone, so he just set himself perfectly right in front of the net, and he knew exactly where he was going to locate that puck.
Face off to the left of Heflin, Bauer against Holmgren. Moskaluk's got it, trying to clear it along the near side. It's Kuda. Backhand from Opilka gets the job done. Poke check there, and John Moskaluk could be free. Here comes John, the sophomore, moving in. And he's tied up a little bit by Kuda, and he's going to draw a penalty. So one against three, only 24 seconds gone by on the power play for Illinois State. It's going to be a minute 36 of four-on-four play as Illinois State goes to the box.
John Moskaluk is hungry tonight for some goals. That's the second time we've seen him sneak out and have a great breakaway opportunity. And this time he draws a penalty. So we're going to have four-on-four action, which is huge for the Illini with their lineup they have of Ernsting and McGing. But right now we have Moskaluk and Holmgren out there. So that has to say a lot about the depth of this team.
Nate Kuda goes to the box. 2 minutes for hooking. His first game of the weekend. Pair of number eights. One in each penalty box right now. 7:30 left in the second period. 6-0 Illinois. Cristiano Simonetta with you alongside Eric Fisher. Here's Chance Holmgren on the right circle. He's got Moskaluk. Back in front for Holmgren, and a save made, fought off. And now as we see a new goaltender in, it's Mark Hayton. So Garoppolo got the start. Mark Hayton comes back in, trying to not pour some salt on the wound there by getting their starter back in. It's a move from Bobby DiNardi. Do you like it, or do you think, why even risk starting your goaltender in a game like this?
I don't like it because I just don't see any point in it. It's a 6-0 game right now. It's not going to bring more life to your team. It's not going to give them more drive that they can come back from a 6-0 deficit.
And here's Stephen Quinn, who lost his stick, and he takes his respective defenseman Corcoran's blade. And now each player has their respective lumber. And here's number 6, Justin Reese. Check to the corner by Pushcheck. 30 seconds, a 4-on-4 time. Rittendale with a drive, and that's gobbled up by Hayton, who we saw play in last night's game. We want to get his official stat line. Number 30, 5'11", 170, 0-3-2 on the season. 3.97 goals against, but that save percentage, just like Garoppolo's, over 900.
And that's all you can ask for from your goaltender, because there's only so much he can do, and there's so much your defense has to do to help back you up. So save percentage really shows how much the goaltender's influence is on the game.
Quinn wins the draw for Nolan. Nolan to Rittendale, right point. Joey Rittendale fires one, tipped on goal. Save made in a rebound, and Stephen Quinn right in the middle of it, as we expect him and Grant Stuve, as there's going to be a penalty on Quinn, as I think he slew-footed Addy. And here's Mika Young fanning on the play. And the Illini, I thought, gained possession. Now they finally do. And that's a penalty from Stephen Quinn you don't really like. It's a dangerous play. Addy shakes his hand a little bit. Quinn with some more words. He'll go to the box. It'll be a 4-on-3 for 10 seconds.
Yeah, that's not what you want to see out of the Illini. You're coming into this game, and this is the second time that you have two guys in the penalty box at once. You have to play a lot more cleaner, especially once the Illini start heading into divisional play.
Exactly. With teams that can operate at the power play of like 20-plus, sure, you look at Illinois State's, not the best. They come into tonight, 7.4. You're not going to find that in a tough division like the CSCHL.
No, as soon as they start heading over to Ohio to play, then they're not going to be able to get away with stuff like this.
And Nick Verini, you know his short leash with players that take penalties that they really shouldn't. And it's a 4-on-3 momentarily for 5 seconds. And then we will have a period of 25 seconds of 4-on-4 as Condotti steps out of the box right on cue. Then after that, it'll be a 5-on-4 as Nolan tried to block a pass. Then it's Robert Collada. Maybe a 2-on-1 for Illinois State. Collada going to the right side. He moves. He fires. He scores! Robert Collada and the junior jump into the boards. 6-1. Collada scores. And also, it's an even strength goal. So in 11 seconds, the Redbirds will be back on the power play.
Just got to tip your cap to Collada on that goal. He faked off Heflin perfectly, making him think that he was going to pass it across the ice. But no, he just goes glove side on Heflin, which is weird to see because Heflin's usually great with his glove, so he just must have thought 100% that he was going to pass that puck off, but nope, fakes him off and buries it in the back of the net for the ISU's
and
first goal of the
boy,
game.
Boy, was Collada pumped up on that one. That's what you want to see, though, from your roster.
Oh, absolutely.
5 goals. We've seen the weirdest things happen in hockey, and now you have a power play coming in the next 5 seconds. 6-1 our score here. Grossinger Motors Arena.
We're getting there.
We're getting there, right?
We're getting
Grossinger
there.
Mortar Arena.
Mortar.
Oh, I did that on purpose. I'm sorry. Now back at the right point. Here's Ernsting. Now back at the right point. Maybe they should just rename it Grossinger Mortar. Maybe.
I think so. I mean, it comes off the tongue better.
And now
a
scrum at the far corner. As we got Pushcheck involved. We got another member of the Illini, McGing and Ernsting tangled. As you see a close-up on your screen right now, thanks to Mackenzie Bach zooming in.
I like what I saw out of McGing there. He didn't try to get involved at all. He was just talking to Ernsting the whole time, probably telling him, hey, it's 6-1 right now. We don't need any sort of fights or anything breaking out. But it looks like Ernsting's sliding over to the box here.
My suggestion is that it's going to be offsetting minors. Ernsting goes, yes. Number 22, Anthony Corcoran. But Illinois State's going to remain on the power play. Minute 8. I believe it's going to be
four on five.
I mean, it depends. So it depends how the referee's going to rule it. If it's the same penalty, it's coincidental. Minors will stay 5-on-4. If they deem them two different penalties, we'll see 4-on-3. Referees conversing down there.
If it is 4-on-3, though, that has to be in favor of ISU, though, because they're just coming off a series of plays where they're able to score just like that.
6-1 our score. 5:18 left in the second period. Collada with the latest goal for ISU. Melton had the one last night. And as we see it played up on the Jumbotron here, he was so pumped for that goal, and great for him because he leads his team in goals. And he's a guy where if you give him space, you got to respect it. 5 goals on the year and 8 points.
Oh, absolutely. And that just has to be a little bit momentum boost for your team, because it shows you, like, hey, we could actually score against these guys. We could if we play to our potential, we could play with them and hang with them. And so a goal like that really boosts the confidence of your team and your line mates, because it assures them that, hey, we deserve to be here playing against this team.
Yeah, it was that tangle along the far side corner, Corcoran and Ernsting. And Ernsting's not a guy to really be chirping, as we look at his penalty minutes on the year. Two
penalties.
So now four. He's not a guy that you're going to find in scrums, especially with a man like Pushcheck or Corcoran. And Corcoran has four penalties. Pushcheck, though, leads the team with 33. That reminds me of Cruikshank or McGing a couple years ago.
Oh, yeah, but this year we're not seeing that out of those guys. But instead, we're seeing it out of the third line, third and second line guys like Quinn and Ernsting, Quinn, who's saw a good amount of penalty minutes so far last weekend and this weekend. And so what you want to see out of that, Ernsting, a guy that doesn't get a lot of penalty minutes, is you want to see him try to keep his composure, because if he does that, he's going to be an essential player for this Illini team. And we've been seeing him on the first penalty kill line and on the special team, so it's going to hurt having him in the box when it comes to penalty kills.
So now Wicklund enters the box. I'm assuming that he's going to serve an extra minor. So they may have given Ernsting a 10. But we'll see what's going on here. Just a couple of seconds, though. Is this a 5-on-3 for Illinois State? Dan Addy right circle. Over and across. Now for Norway. Down low. Again for Addy. Near side. Nolan tried to jump him. Instead, it's played down low. Illinois State with a crucial opportunity to get back in this hockey game. Joe Nolan can't get the puck out. It's Kuda. Now Cruikshank does the job, though. So those three out. Illinois State pestering, but Illinois keeping their composure.
Yeah, ISU's making the right passes on this 5-on-3. They're just bouncing off the stick, and if they want to convert, you can't be having that.
We've still got 30 seconds of 5-on-3 time, as now Trevor Hansen gains the line along the far side corner, near side corner, right circle. Hansen bumped a bit by Kandati. Some aggressive checking here while defending against a 5-on-3. Here's Joey Bauer. Bauer at the left circle, has some space, moving in. He shoots one off the blocker of Heflin. Instinct there from the senior to knock it across the far side as a man goes down. That was Norway. Bauer wanted a call. 4 seconds left on the 5-on-3. Here's Ambersat. Ambersat over for Hansen. Now again, Ambersat back for Hansen. Left circle. Illinois State changing there at the end of a power play instead of keeping one last rush. 40 seconds left on the 5-on-4 now. 4 minutes left in the second period. 6-1 Illinois. But it's all to the outside, Eric, as you know.
Yep. Rindale having none of that in the corners, swatting the puck multiple times.
Now down low, Illinois State with a push attempt, and that one couldn't go. And Quinn and Counter get the puck out. 20 seconds left on Ernsting's minor. Now here's Melton. He can't even get the puck in, and Quinn knocks it down. So a rejuvenated penalty-killing group drastically from what we saw last season for Illinois.
And they're just taking advantage of ISU's mistakes now on this power play. Just very sloppy, unable to get any real offense set up.
Here's Collada with a bad angle shot. 3 seconds left on the 5-on-4. Melton missed Hansen, and this could be a 3-on-1 for Illinois. Here's Wicklund out of the box. John Moskalik left circle as a man cutting. Moskalik going to his back, and in front. Oh, he had a wide open homer and said he was knocked down into the cage. Moskalik, probably his best game, even though he had 2 goals against Michigan State. He stood out at every end of the ice. Right, here's Holmgren playing it back for Wicklund. Wicklund fires one. That's blocked. Holmgren draws a slashing minor. Mussey's going to go to the box, so Heflin goes off. No tolerance policy from these referees. 17 minutes and 11 seconds into the second. Illinois, a chance to go, what is it, 3 straight power plays with a goal?
I think so. It's going to be interesting to see how they play this faceoff, because the goal before their last one, they had a beautiful setup for Holmgren to bury it in the back of the net. And the last time, they just passed the puck a lot more. They were getting in behind the net, and they're just getting the defense moving side to side. So it's going to be very interesting as we have, it looks like, the first power play lineup coming out with McGee, Cruikshank, Stuve, Opilka, and not Ernsting as he's heading over to the bench.
Yeah, if you're head coach Nick Fabrini, you got to look. They're waiting for Ernsting, and instead they'll throw out Richter. And relating to Fabrini, he's talking to Ernsting right now about it, so he's probably saying, hey, let's figure out what happened. Let's figure out how to prevent it for next time when it could cost you possibly against a divisional foe.
Because Ernsting's not a guy that's going to draw a penalty, man. So Fabrini, very curious of what happened in that situation.
Illini power play underway. It's James McGing. Now for Opilka straightaway. Brookshank right circle. Brookshank fakes. That's Opilka again. Tyler Opilka fires one, stick to side by Hayton. Out of the far side corner, half boards now. Crookshank waiting. Now for Opilka. Opilka to Crookshank, he fires one. Swallowed by Hayton, no rebound. We got two goaltenders right now. Sure, Joey Garoppolo started, but right now, Hayton spectacular, as is Heflin, at preventing rebounds and really getting in front of that puck, not letting it be scored away.
Well, like I mentioned yesterday, they're two very similar goaltenders where they might not have the size advantage, but they have great vision and awareness and amazing rebound control.
Faceoff to the left of Hayton. Minute 37 left on the Illini power play. Stube plays it back for McGang. McGang gaining the line, holding the line. Now back on the near side, half boards for Stube. Look for Grant Stube to strike right in that high slot position. He'll assume that point right now. Opilka for McGang. Illinois so patient, getting the right spot. There's a chance for Crookshank for the hat trick. That one's rung around the boards. Gets through a man. What a move by Ernston. Quick play. And now McGang across. Crookshank just went wide. Or that was Stube. Great passing there from Illinois in such a tight area where you don't expect a lot of passes to get through. Here's McGing. McGing for Opilka. Opilka, high slot pass. Pushing it away for Crookshank at the far side. 55 seconds left in the Illini power play. Stube goes in below. Senior forward. Roselle, Illinois native. Back to the Effingham, Illinois native. Opilka now for Stube again. His shot was blocked. Here comes Joe Pirelli. Could be a chance on a two-on-one. Instead, Opilka gloves it down. He missed it. Now here comes Pushcheck. Pushcheck on the back, and he fires it a save made by Heflin. Rebound try, and another secondary stop as Pirelli came out. Must have been contact with the goaltender. They blew it dead. Shorthanded try there from ISU. Heflin closes the door, though, on the backhand. 18 minutes and 38 seconds in the second. 6-1 Illinois.
Yeah, that's something that Heflin's great at is manning the fast break opportunities for them. He seems to be the one in control of the situation. Instead of the guy with the scoring opportunity, he really approaches out in front of the net like the aggressive goaltender he is, and then he's always quick to drop to that butterfly whenever the scoring opportunity seems to occur.
Cristiano Simonetta with you. Eric Fisher alongside. 6-1 Illinois. Grossinger Motors Arena.
There you go.
Got that one. You see we're gaining the line, and now here's Moskaluk across. Looking for counter at the far side. Boys, we talked about it yesterday, but again, just a beautiful arena, a beautiful setup here. Illinois State, the Central Illinois Flying Aces. They used to be the Bloomington Thunder of the United States Hockey League. Now, Central Illinois Flying Aces who play in this arena as we get a stoppage of 56.9 seconds. This is just such a cool atmosphere, and we'd like to thank Illinois State for setting us up here.
Oh, absolutely. It's always great to be on the road and to be set up and acquainted with all the things we have here. We have a very nice press box. Food, I would like to hope is a little bit of cheap. That's just me, though. But, no, this is a great arena. It would be great to see this place packed. I can't imagine what the atmosphere would be like.
Novosel with a drive save made. Hayton kicks it along the near side. Novosel again. Pass out in front as Evan Sabo tried to whack at it. Redbirds without his stick. Now he gets it back. Pass on the left corner. Nolan keeps it in. 40 seconds left in the second period. Novosel down low for Wicklund. Wicklund pass out in front looking for a tap-in. Sabo couldn't get to it. Sabo's got the puck again, or at least he thought he was going to get it. Now Norway across. Diagonal pass for Mussey. Gained the blue line far side. Shoots one. Left toe saved by Heflin. Wicklund ties up his man. Illinois with a chance with 20 seconds left in the second period. Novosel's hit. As he had his head turned, legal contact there. Here's Wicklund looking for a backhanded pass. Instead, he moves to his forehand. 10 seconds left in the period. Sabo back to the line. It's Nolan. Nolan out for Rittendale. Joey Rittendale banks one for Novosel. 3 seconds left. He fires one in. Now a backhanded effort from Wicklund. Couldn't get it done. We're through 40 minutes. 6-1 Illinois. The shots are 23 for the Illini, 20 for the Illinois State Redbirds. So not a large chasm of shot disparity in this hockey game, but it's been more about quality when you're head coach Nick Fabrini's club.
Oh, absolutely. Quality over quantity is something that Fabrini has always strived to have his teams do. And ISU on the other end, even though they have been able to keep up with Illinois in shots, the quality of those shots have just not been good. They've been along the boards. They've been from the top of the key. And David Heflin, of course he's going to have vision in that puck, and that's something ISU probably needs to work on, is getting more bodies in front of the Heflin and creating more traffic around him. As we saw that first goal, that's what happened in that situation, was there was a lot of traffic in front of the net, or yesterday's first goal, there was a lot of traffic in front of the net, my bad.
But even this first goal, I hate to interrupt you, they still had guys moving to the front of the net. So there's always that option of a pass. If it's just nobody in front, nobody around the net, it's easy for Heflin to just take that shot by himself.
Oh, absolutely. And he's an aggressive goaltender. So when you're coming at him, he's not going to be a guy that sits in between the pipes. He's going to come out and out in that from the blue box, and he's going to challenge you. And so to see that first goal from ISU, it was very impressive because Heflin was not approaching him. He was trying to play off and play for the pass, and Collada just saw the opportunity and buried it.
And we'll see how the Illinois State Redbirds will attempt to come back in this hockey game, down by 5 goals. We'll get you the second period intermission report. Just a couple minutes. You are watching Illini Hockey, presented by YouTube.
Got to.
Reporting live from the Grossinger Motors Arena for the second period intermission, I'm Abby Kelso alongside Mackenzie Bach, and you're listening to Illini Hockey on YouTube Live. Before we get started in some hockey, there have been a lot of different atmosphere changes for us here compared to the Big Pond. Am I right? Like, there were more suit guys yesterday. We were just on the Kiss Cam. Things are crazy here.
Well, yeah, we were. I was staying at the screen for the longest time. I was like, who is that guy? Like, looks pretty good.
Well, anyways,
a lot of atmosphere changes, for sure. And it's a little disappointing because the stadium is quite empty, frankly.
It's pretty depressing compared to the Big Pond when there's so many people. But anyways, going off of the more exciting things on the ice, this has been a crazy game. High scoring, high energy, a lot of penalty minutes. Let's take a minute about that.
Yeah, no kidding. There was one point in the game where Andrew Wicklund, Stephen Quinn, and was it
Bobby Ernsting,
all three of them in the box at the same time, allowed ISU for a 5-on-3 opportunity. Unfortunately, they did not capitalize on that, but they did capitalize on an earlier power play where they were able to get their first goal of the game. A little bit late in the game, but finally got on the board. So
congratulations to ISU for putting themselves on the board, because when they scored, I think it was as if they had won the Stanley Cup.
The fans were going nuts. And it's nice to see that the fans are finally getting involved, but, I mean, do you think it's a little too late?
Is it too late? Personally, I think it's way too late, because the way the Illini are coming out is exceedingly stronger than the ISU Redbirds. And I realized yesterday they came out just as strong as the Illini did today, and they were pushing us around. And today we came back and we go, hey, you know what? We're not going to let you treat us like that. We're the better team, and we're going to show you that by putting 6 goals past your goaltender.
Is that what they said?
If I had to guess, that's what they would say, Mackenzie.
Okay, just making sure.
But I think the refs have really been stepping up their game this period, especially. They've been calling a lot of good calls. I haven't seen anything that I really haven't disagreed with.
Well, it's not hard when, you've got guys fighting along the boards. Clear elbow, elbowing. They're very blatant play, very, very blatant calls. You really can't go astray there.
It's about that time that they really need to make themselves assertive, because people are getting chippy. There's a lot of high energy. The Redbirds are getting frustrated. After yesterday, I don't really think they thought the Illini were going to come back with such a power move.
Yeah, a lot of high energy for what seems to be no reason, as ISU is very far out of this game.
Well, we have a lot of different scorers coming from every different line, and I'm really impressed with how every line's been playing, specifically the third and fourth lines, who usually you rely on the first and second to kind of get everyone pumping, but the third and fourth lines have really shown that we're here to play hockey. Even the rookies really stepped out.
Oh, absolutely. And that leaves no problem for Coach Fabrini when he's asked the question on what line should he throw out next. Every line is just as strong as the last. So great job by Coach Fabrini for setting those lines up.
But honestly, at this point, do we put Jake Barnhart in? Do we keep David Heflin playing? He's done incredible. He's only let one goal pass. And honestly, the Red Bulls have 20 shots on goal compared to our 23. Like, David Heflin's playing amazing. Do we let the newest goalies on the Illini kind of show himself off at ISU today?
Honestly, that's a great question. We have a 5-goal lead right now. So, there's definitely a good cushion for Jake Barnhart if he was to come in and play. It just depends on how confident Coach Fabrini is and if he wants to take Heflin out, who has been phenomenal up to this point in the game. He's been doing great, but at the same time, you have to question whether or not Heflin is getting overworked. And as we saw yesterday, Heflin played the full 3 periods. We will have to see if he stays in for the last period for this game.
Yeah, kind of going off of that, we have Joey Caprio, senior on the Illini, who's kind of playing with little bit of a tweaked lower body injury right now, and he only plays in the PK, so he has been kind of hanging out, not playing too much, only played when he's really needed. But is he really needed? Honestly, like, we have so many younger guys that are ready and they can handle that. If you were Coach Nick Fabrini, would you try out kind of different people on the PK, maybe more rookies, maybe more people in the third and fourth lines instead of your same seniors every time?
Oh, absolutely, no question. Joey Caprio, yesterday, I believe it was within the first few minutes of the game, Caprio got a knee to, I believe it was the side of his knee, and he was hobbling around for the rest of the game, and even after the game, hobbling around with a bag of ice taped to his leg. So I don't think that there is really any reason, especially against ISU, where we already have a 5-goal lead, to continue playing Caprio when there are plenty of other guys that can definitely come into that position. And get the opportunity to show Coach Fabrini if they have what it takes.
Right, and that's exactly kind of what's been going on with our own power play. You've seen guys like Chance Homer and John Mosco score, but they're not the people you expect. Obviously, you're expecting your James McGee, your Eric Cruikshank, that line to really capitalize in that power play, but we have, you know, the second, third, fourth line really stepping it up, and they're playing a little bit more in the power play. What do you think about that?
It's phenomenal. Like I was telling you earlier, leaves no question for Coach Fabrini on what line should he put in for the power play. But at the same time, when it comes to the PKs, no question at all, because all four lines are phenomenal defensively as well, which you don't think about too much, but it, you know, it says a lot about this team in general.
Right, and like Cristiano said it earlier, it's pretty much night and day in our PK and our power plays from last year. Can you talk a little bit more about how specifically you see that today?
Honestly, we haven't been allowing the puck to, for the PKs that is, we haven't been allowing the puck to get worked around. We continue to pressure the Redbirds today, and we have been throughout this year so far in our past three games played. That's the biggest thing, is that we are applying more pressure to our opponents and just not allowing them room to work the puck.
Right, I think that everybody's kind of taking a step in the right direction when it comes to defense and backing up our goaltender, which is what ISU is lacking and what we kind of lacked last year.
Yeah, absolutely. He's a brick wall no matter what, but it definitely helps that our defense is getting more involved and preventing shots on goal, just helping Heflin out just that much more.
Okay, well, going into the third, who's going to score to finish up this game?
I don't even know if that's the question here. Honestly, it's who's going to be the agitators in this game to, maybe get an ISU's on ISU's nerves if they're not already, you know?
Yeah, you know what? I think Eric Cruikshank is going to get his hat trick. I'm going to knock on wood right here if that's real wood. And I'm going to hope I think Eric Cruikshank is going to get his hat trick. Well, thank you very much for your insight. I'm Abby Kelso alongside Mackenzie Bach. Cristiano and Mackenzie will have the call in just a few moments. This has been your Illini Hockey Intermission Report from the Grossinger Motors Arena.
We welcome you back in for the third period here, Grossinger Motors Arena here in Bloomington, Illinois. I'm Cristiano Simonetta, joined alongside Mackenzie Bach. Nice to hear your voice again. Great job in the intermission report. You and Abby Kelso, 6-1 Illinois over the Illinois State Redbirds. Is it going to be a little too late, though? Is this lead, we talk about 3-goal lead being the worst lead in hockey, but 5 goals, should that be insurmountable going into this final frame?
Oh, absolutely. For ISU to come back from this, it would take a goal, you know, within the first 2 minutes of this game at the very least. So for ISU, the biggest thing that they can work on right now is puck control and making sure that they control possession of the puck.
Underway here for the third period, Eric Cruikshank with 2 goals. Other than that, it's 4 goals from 4 different goal scorers. Illinois flexing their respective offensive muscles in this weekend. Scored 5 last night, currently 6 now. They scored 8 in one game against Michigan State. That's their highest of the season so far. Here's Joe Nolan. He fires one. Sticked away by Mark Hayton. Bobby Nannardi sticking with his backup for the night, but usual starter, as Joey Garoppolo was pulled in the first period. Second period. Over into the near side boards. Here's Jake Ambrosat. Ambrosat now up in Illinois trying to rejuvenate the rush. Instead, it's number 97, Joey Bauer. Gain the line, left circle. floated one through, no receiver. Now on the end boards, Nolan again, punches one through. Won't go far enough for icing. We're 60 seconds through, last period of regulation, 6-1 Illinois. I want to thank you for tuning in on YouTube.com. Our next telecast will be using WPGU 1071's audio as well as the video stream next week against Northern Illinois University at the Big Pond. So it'll be a great chance for Illinois to come back home, hopefully, after a weekend sweep against ISU. But so much time is left in this third period, you never know. As Collada tried to get to the puck instead, it's Cruikshank for Stuve. Passes too far for him. The bromance, those two, 15 and 25. Nicknamed Crooksy and Evesy, and they told us to call them that. Now here's Crooksy with a drive, and that one went high.
No, I believe he asked us to call him Shanksy.
Or Shanksy.
Shanksy.
He's got
Shanksy
two nicknames. He's got Crooksy, he's got Shanksy. Nonetheless, we can call him goal scorer tonight. He's got two.
Man of many names.
We call him Mr. Third Period, the number 15 strike in this final frame. Not yet, but now here's Mark Condotti, who's had a solid weekend. Gains the line, right circle. He shoots one, knocked into the air, hits the netting. 2:04 into the third period, 6-1 Illini.
Speaking of last names, ISU here with a quarterback duo with Garoppolo and Glennon.
And one isn't on the roster, one isn't starting.
Should be starting, arguably, on a starting team.
Oh, yes. Okay, I was going to say.
Not quite over Tom Brady.
If you go over Tom Brady, I know Jimmy Garoppolo's excellent already. But, yeah, Mike Glennon.
Not
doing it.
No. Start Sanchez.
Mark Sanchez, is that what
they call? Because I know they're not going to start Trubisky anytime soon. So at least give Sanchez a start to – at least give him the opportunity to wipe away the butt fumble, which he's very renowned for.
We saw the knee fumble, though, this week off of Glennon against the Packers. So you never know what the Bears – football season is underway. Hockey season starts next Wednesday. Pittsburgh Penguins – banner-raising ceremony against the St. Louis Blues will be a lot of fun. Right now we got ACHA Hockey, Division I, 6-1 Illini over the Illinois State Redbirds. Chance Holmgren has a goal tonight off a blistering slap shot on the power play. He turned it over, though. Here's Young with a drive. That was blocked by number 9 in orange and gray. Stephen Quinn with a backhand. Now for John Moskaluk. Could be a 3-on-2 for Illinois. Moskaluk. His pass was blocked by Young all the way. Backhand in front. Quinn, oh, he just pushed it wide. Oh, the third line with some masterful passing. It's now Holmgren. Back for Graham. Bucked in below for Quinn. He battles for it along the half boards. Now to Holmgren. Deeks around Glennon. And deeks around another. Look at Chance Holmgren splitting two. And he turns back. With that candy cane tape job on his stick. You recognize him from a mile away. He goes off for a change. His pass goes between Graham's legs. 16:57 left in the third period. 6-1 Illinois. How about Moskaluk going forehand to backhand? Gains the red line, gains the blue line. Mussey tries to cancel him out. He'll dump it in, allowing his defensive partners to go for some changes. Dan Addy, heaviest player on this Illinois State team with 220 pounds to his name. Nate Kuda, in his first bit of action, gets the puck far. Not far enough as Illinois off the rush. Here's Novosel. Novosel down the right circle, has Wicklund across. Great stretch pass. That was knocked down by the stick of a pair of Redbirds. Evan Sabo battling. Now down low for Novosel. Novosel with some time, throws one in, and that's a stop by Mark Hayton. There's no such thing as a bad shot. Novosel exercised that concept. And 16:18 left in the third period. The fourth line, they've been not just holding their own, but really forcing the attack, which is a blessing if you're head coach Dick Verini, who told me last year that a good weekend is goals from all four lines, and he's got that.
Absolutely. A blessing for the Illini, but a tragedy for ISU.
We'll see how the Redbirds respond here. Face off in their zone. They lose it. Now back to the right point for Rittendale. He fires one that's blocked. Almost kept in by Opilka. It's delayed offsides. 3 minutes and 50 seconds into the third period. Ross Lippick was supposed to get the start tonight for the Illini, or today, rather, I should say. It's David Heflin instead. Long shot, knocked down on the near side. Back to the left point for Corcoran. Now bad angle try from Bauer, now to the middle area. Bit of a lull here, now to left circle for Norway. Norway out in front, and Amberset fan on the shot. 15:40 left in the third period. Novosel up for Sabo, who tips it in. Corcoran to take. Anthony Corcoran, 7 games played, 1 goal, 3 assists. Backhanded sauce now through the middle for Amberset. He made a man miss. Amberset to left circle. He fires. Glove stopped by Heflin. No rebound allowed. 4:35 into the third period. The goaltender's best stop of the night right there.
I mean, I think the night in general has been phenomenal for him, especially coming off of the game he had yesterday where he played all three periods. You know, is he getting overworked?
I don't know. We'll have to ask him after the game if he thinks that he's a little bit tired, or maybe he just loves playing in the orange and gray and standing tall in that crease.
I really hope Ross Lipik is okay, because he was supposed to get the start tonight.
And Jake Barnhart was supposed to back Lipik up instead, number one, backing up Heflin tonight. I don't think they're going to need him, though, with this five-goal lead. 21 shots on goal for Illinois State, 20 saves for Heflin, and at the other end, 27 shots for Illinois. Pass out in front. Kalata, the only goal scorer for ISU tonight, takes it down the near side. Oh, and a knee on knee. David Kellner was taken out by number 10. That was Basesi. Two on one the other way. Here's Ernsting. He fires over the blocker and met the glass. And that was a dangerous, dangerous hit there from Connor Basesi, sticking out the knee. They'll give him a tripping minor. That could have been detrimental for the ACL, MCL, whatever, PCL of David Kellner. Luckily, he's okay.
And David Kellner, who's been doing phenomenal these past two games, you would have hated to see if he would have gone down. Fortunately, he got it real quick and was able to get back into the play.
2 minutes for tripping. Illinois to another power play. They're seventh of the night. A lot of penalty minutes in this game. We only saw 8 minutes apiece last night. Maybe it's because it's necessarily a blowout, a five-goal lead early. It was 6-0 at one point, which must cause the fracas that we've seen after the whistles and during the play too. Illini go to work. James McGain, great pass for Cruikshank. The hat trick attempt, that was knocked down. And this could be trouble. Opilka trying to get back. Here comes number 11. That's Glenn, and he moves in, and that shot was knocked away. It's so easy for Tyler Opilka to get back. He's so smooth on his skates. And now here's Stuve at neutral ice. He brings the puck back. Glennon hoped to maneuver through him, could not. McGain spins one and drops one. Stuve saucer to Cruikshank, 3-on-2. Cruikshank gains the line, he fanned on the pass. Minute 23 left in the Illini power play. Stuve back to the line. Here's Opilka, fresh off the change. Here's Kellner, out in front. Oh, and if it was a right-handed shot, instead of a left-handed Grant Stuve, it would have been a tapping. But it's tough on your backhand to get handcuffed there.
Very close, very close.
But Kellner again with some great dishes. Here at the other end, it's Bauer. Bauer in his back, and he fires at a save mate. And that's off the outside of the cage. And they'll blow the whistle there. But Bauer had space above the blocker of Heflin. But going the waffle back, board stops.
Yeah, going back to that last opportunity by the Illini, that was almost a similar goal if it would have gone in by Grant Stuve like last night when he just stood in front of the net, got in that slot area, and was able to take it home.
Yeah, it doesn't matter how pretty they are. They're called garbage goals, those right in front, those tip plays, those deflections, but they all matter in the score sheet the same.
All that's required is for the puck to cross the line.
Exactly. The Illini have done that 6 times tonight. Here's Holmgren and the rest of the power play grouping attempting to make it 7. Here's Joe Nolan. He's got space. He may split the D. Joe Nolan, what a pass all the way across. And oh, and a wide open chance for number 19, Kellner. Couldn't get it done. Kellner out in front. Richter score. Power play goal. It's Drew Richter. Kellner again with the primary assist. 6:37 into the third period. The extra point. It's good.
Drew Richter, second goal of the night, might I add as well. Phenomenal job. Way to read that play and pick up that easy goal.
Drew Richter, he scored his first goal last night, gets another tonight. Boy, what a great pass from Kellner. They're working that near side. Instead of going around, they're just stopping there, feeding it in front. And Richter, all he has to do is shovel it past the blocker of Hayton and does it excellent. Boy.
For ISU, how do you continue moving on with a deficit this large?
You just got to end the game strongly. I mean, it doesn't matter what the score is now. It's pretty clear that the Illini are going to sweep them this weekend. But they were 3-1 against Iowa State. Both games. And here's a shot and a quick save by Heflin. And they only lost 4-1 in those games. So against Iowa State, a team in the CSCHL similar to the Illini. But the Illini are just so much stronger offensively this weekend than Iowa State perhaps was against them. So you just got to move on. It's a long season. As Novosel clears one off the side of the net. And you just got to keep it moving. And now Sabo with a try and a save made. Oh, the former Redbird.
He wants
We've
that goal.
Set it all
he
weekend
wants that
long.
Goal.
We talked to him on Thursday. He really wants to strike one against his former school. Hayton, though, you want an example of how to move forward? Starts with your goaltender right there who makes a good save.
Absolutely. For the ISU Redbirds head coach, do you consider to start treating this like a scrimmage and starting to play different players that normally don't play on different lines?
Yeah, that's what you got to do. You got to mix up your lines. You got to mix up something. Get a play generated, a good shift. All it is you take it one shift at a time, and that's how you move on from a pair of losses like this where they were dominated. This is Sabo and Reese. Now it's Opilka firing one in. It's the blocker of Hayton. The other way, it's Joe Pirelli with 12:13 left in the third period. 7-1 Illinois. As you update the scoreboard right now that you're watching on YouTube. Now back to the left point. It's Mullally. Mullally now for an unnamed 23. Hope to get his information. He's got the puck right now. Back to the left point. It's Mullally. Right point for Duckman. He fires one. That was blocked in front. Duckman again with a sprawling try. Kandati grabs it and tosses one ahead. A scramble there, and now it's a one-on-one. Here's Ernsting. Ernsting has McGing floating through the low slot. Here's Ernsting trying to deke through a man. He's got the puck still. He has Kandati at the far point. Now what a great pass. Jack Graham fires, and that was over the glove. And Jack Graham has been fine tonight, too. So some depth on the Illini on defense. Now here's counter. Out in front for Graham. He fires one blocked, and that will go into the netting. 8 minutes and 34 seconds into the third period. 7-1 Illinois. They've got 29 shots on goal as opposed to the Redbirds, 23.
Yeah, did you see that puck get stuck in the netting? This could be a delayed game here?
No, it was deflected off of an Illinois State Redbird. So as long as it's not intentionally cleared by Illinois State, it wouldn't be a delay of game. Because it was a shot from Graham that was blocked upwards, all that happens is that there's a faceoff in the Illinois State zone.
And so they're going to leave the puck in the netting?
I guess so. I mean, usually there's some fans that can go grab it. But, yeah, it technically, if there's a big hit along the boards, we could see a puck pop into play. So
two pucks, that'll be quite the circus act.
I mean, trying to get ISU into the game, I guess. Score two goals at once. And now here's Mika Young. Setting it on a tee for Kyle Melton at the right circle. He backhands one in far. Heflin didn't even have to move there. Now Glennon interchanges. Melton drops it for Corcoran. Corcoran along the near side. Throws one in. On the backhand, it's Glennon. Twisting one in front, and Young couldn't get it. Now Cruikshank playing it off the boards to himself. He always loves this play. One on four. Rest of his teammates are changing. Cruikshank trying to go through. What a move! Cruikshank off the goal!
Oh.
That would have been a highlight reel goal. Instead, banged one off the crossbar. Cruikshank hoping for that third strike.
So close yet so far.
Oh,
hate
man.
To see that.
Split four. Oh, that would have been an unreal move.
You know he wants that one back.
As Richter and Pushcheck exchange some cross checks at the top of your screen. Nothing coming out of it. 10:20 left in the third period. Here's Jake Ambersat. Ambersat for Anthony Corcoran. Now for Joey Bauer at the line. He dumps one in. Mark Kandati. He's got to have at least 13 minutes tonight. Drops one off for Holmgren. Chance Holmgren. A lot of space moving through the neutral zone. Now here's Drew Richter. Richter moves in. What a backdoor play. And instead it was speared aside by Dan Addy and dumped all the way down. Heflin out to play it. No trapezoid here. And the ACHA, Heflin just holds on to it. Some mind games there as the puck goes down. This will not go on net as a result. An icing, 10 minutes and 12 seconds into the third period. Smooth sailing for the visitors moving forward. And they've done it all night. Cristiano Simonetta with you right now. Mackenzie Bach alongside. Grossinger, Motors Arena, Bloomington, Illinois. 7-1, though. Do we expect, I mean, we talked about it a lot. But seven goals, could this team put up seven goals consistently even against divisional opponents, or do you think that they're going to be brought down to earth a little bit?
I think they will be brought down to earth just a little bit. I mean, this is like a heyday for the Illini as they are just ripping shots left and right on Mark Hayton now as he has replaced former goaltender. But, yeah, I think they definitely will be brought down to earth.
Illinois State having the puck in the skates now. Richter with a quick play. Lays one out for Holmgren. Holmgren trying to saucer one ahead. That was for Nolan. You always see Joe Nolan. I mean, he's an offensive defenseman by trade, but his ability to join the rush at will is quite phenomenal. Now on the far side, it's Addy. Puck is taken from him by Moskaluk. Possession stays on Illinois State. Unless a turnover just happened, and it did. Now here's Jack Graham. He fires glove. Stop. Oh, Jack Graham looking for his first goal of the year. He's got it now. On his skate, great backhand pass for Opilka. He fires, deflected off the blocker of Hayton to the far side. Graham is tied up. Here's Novacell, a lot of space. Novacell over for Opilka. Fan on the drive, dumps one in below for Justin Reese. Carl Sandburg High School graduate, had 56 points last year in high school. Now for Moskalk, who backhanded one. Addy checks him off the puck. Now for Bosasi at the far side. Cleared down, 8:30 left in the third period. 7-1 Illinois. Opilka springing Moskalk. Two-line pass, great toe drag there from Moskalk. Can he keep the puck? He does. A turnover there as Mullally jumped her up. Jack Graham does a pirouette. Plays it for Opilka. Sets it up on a tee for Novosel. They interchange. Opilka down the near side. He fires one. Save made by Hayton. He'll hold on. 11 minutes and 42 seconds into the third period. Do you see the physicality ramping up, though? This game's getting close to the end. And we've seen some cross-checks during the play. We've seen Ernsting involved in a scrum. Clean, smooth sailing from here on out? Or do you think there's going to be one big event that's going to spark a brawl?
You know, I mean, I'm sure the crowd here, you know, with nothing to cheer about, with one goal by the Redbirds, I think they would like to see a scrum. However, I think play is going to start dying out as we have 8 minutes left on the clock.
Nolan to Rittinelli fires one in, blocked by the shin pads of Mullally. And excavated beautifully and lofted along the boards. Here's Joe Nolan. 34 shots for the Illini tonight. It's Evan Sabo. Sabo down the right circle. He really wants that goal to the backhand. A force to the end boards. As Cruikshank had a man in front instead threw it all the way down. Playing catch with his goaltender here. Giving Heflin some action. Hasn't seen a lot of shots this period. He'll set Rittendale up. Now for Nolan. Nolan fakes one. Looking in the middle. Puck is poked. Now here comes Cruikshank. Cruikshank and Corcoran. Corcoran wins that battle now from Melton. And the Illini, their next action is going to be against Northern Illinois University, a D2 team. Then they have McKendree University, another D2 team. So do you think that we talk about the concept of bringing a team back to earth. Are they going to build themselves up too much? And we don't know what's going to happen in those next four games against McKendree and NIU. Let's say they win them all. And then they play against Lindenwood and teams like Iowa State, Davenport, Jamestown, all ranked opponents. Is there a bit of a dark shadow over this early season prominence?
If you're asking if they're going to come into those games overconfident, I think they know that those are going to be tougher games, and I think they're going to prepare much, much more for those games. I don't think that Coach Fabrini's style of playing Heflin in a game like this is going to help mentally prepare them. I think if he would have started someone like Jake Barnhart, who is a freshman goaltender, just to give him the reps, and then play Heflin in the games that mattered, I think that would help the Illini get into that mindset better. But regardless, I think they still will prepare harder for those games and will come into them knowing what to expect.
As Max Pushchak gets 2 minutes for cross-checking, mouths off to the official, and gets a 10-minute misconduct. So we look at Pushchak's numbers coming into the game. He already had a pair of minors. Not just a pair of minors. 33 coming in. He gets 4 minutes, and then he gets 10. And I told Eric in the second period, it reminded me a lot of James McGang and Eric Kruschick, because Pushchak's a guy, he can produce, he can be really effective. He has 3 assists on the year, but there's really no reason to do that. 6:38 left, except keep your team shorthanded.
Is he getting a penalty?
Well, there's one listed, but there's got to be someone serving it. And I'm glad you pointed down to the penalty box there, which remains vacant.
I think they're trying to figure that out right now.
Yeah, the only person in the penalty box is a man in a suit. I don't think Pushchak has changed into his street clothes that quickly. But yes, finally they're having a man skate over. I believe that's Bosasi. Serve that penalty.
Trying to evade that. Trying to run away.
6:38 left in the third. Christian Simmons with you. Mackenzie Bach alongside. Illinois to another power play. Nolan couldn't handle it. One hand on his stick, though, as Pirelli was charging against him, and he dodges that. Richter now for Holmberg. A revamped power play line. Here's Holmberg gaining the line now. Oh, his counter took a tumble. Hopefully the knee's okay from that earlier hit.
He just blew a tire there.
He just blew a tire, tripped over the blue line, if you will. Now here's Nolan. Pass was blocked. Dangerous area. Holmgren, all he's going to do is whack it down. This will not go far enough for icing, though. 35 seconds gone by in the Illini power play. No shot so far. Moskalk dumps it in behind. Here's Kellner. Fighting for it and gets it. Retrieves it. Gets it back for Richter. loves this play where he just takes it and drops it off. Instead, Holmgren was knocked away by Trevor Hansen, who, look at the stick jabs and everything like that. There's some passion in this hockey game no matter what the score is, as Hansen tried to deliver a big blow to Richter. And we've got a bit of a tie-up here. They're trying to move the puck, and they're eventually just going to whistle this one down. 1:06 gone by in the power play, 14:29 in the third period.
Now I have a question for you, Cristiano. If you are Coach Fabrini on a 10-minute power play,
well, it's a misconduct, so it's only a 2-minute power play.
Oh, okay, I see.
So it's the first 2-minute and then a 10-minute, but go on.
On a power play like this, and like this large, with a lead of 7-1, do you start or do you tease the idea of playing Sable more just because this is his former team?
Your question's answered. He's right there. So there you go.
Do you think he's going to get
extra playing time? What are you, Nostradamus or something?
Do you think he's going to get extra playing time now?
You have to think so. I mean, you reward players. Like you'll see on senior night, you'll see 5 seniors start or 6 seniors start. Given a guy in his home university, pretty cool to see. Let's see if Sable can capitalize. 30 seconds left in the Illini power play. It's McGing over to Cruikshank. One timer, and that's stopped by Hayden. McGing gets the puck. Sabo's right in that high slot looking for a deflection. And you know they're going to want to get the puck to the front of the net. Here's Cruikshank. 2 goals on the night. What a saucer pass across. This is Stuve. Twisting and turning with the puck. It's spun out by Kalata. 10 seconds left in the power play. One last rush for Illinois on the man advantage. Sabo still out there, though, at that far side wing. Top of your screen, 28. Left-handed shot. And now Mussey clears it. Nothing doing on that power play. Not the best one, but it is a 7-1 hockey game. Under 4.5 to go now.
Definitely not much on the line for the Illini with that.
Yeah, so there's no reason to force anything. Just work on some fundamentals. Make crisp passes. This is Novosel board to the corner. Ambersat tried with her reverse hit.
Taking each other up.
Yeah, both men go down. Ambersat's got it, though. He escapes. Here's Jake. Jake pushing off a man in the far corner. Now straight away moving down low. Pass handcuffed number 19, Adam Howie, a bit. And Young behind with Howie. Howie to the far side. Stiff arming a man away. That was Reese, but Reese took the puck. Leaves it for Opilka. And the man they call Reese's Pieces brings it back to the top of the slot. Illinois can't get it out, though. Opilka. One hand on his stick. Now for Novosel. Novosel launches one. Puck comes out. It's Reese. Takes a hit to make a play. Here's Wicklund right circle. Andrew Wicklund fires one of that sticked away. Meets the glass. Now Novosel already has a goal tonight. Checked by Ambersat. 3.5 to go in the third period. Behind the net now for Mussey. Mussey reverses for Addy. Addy tosses one down off the glove of Condotti. No icing. Heflin out to play it. And David Heflin, if the score is insurmountable here and it ends at a 7-1 affair, he moves to 3-0 on the season. You can't ask for much more out of your starting netminder, especially one in his senior year of college.
Oh, absolutely, and that just makes it that much more special.
We'll see how he can build off of this if he'll get the start against NIU as Trevor Hansen pinches in along the left circle. He tried to throw one in front, and Dottie meets him there. Directly behind David Heflin. Puck comes in behind again. Now here's Wicklund. So you want to mention Evan Sabo getting some more ice time along the fourth line. He's got it. Here comes Evan Sabo, right circle. Still has it. Sabo, moving and he fires, and that's a save made from Mark Hayton. He looked off the pass and shot it anyway. Hayton denies his former teammate. But if he scores, though, that's going to be quite the event, as now Kalata with Sable in front. Here's a chance for Wicklund. He gets brought down, and another power play coming for the Illini. Fourth line, these minutes are a chance to show, because there's always a rotating cast on the fourth line.
Right.
So these minutes are a chance to show head coach Jake Fabrini what you got and what will you do for us moving forward. So those three have been humming. Charlie Salk nursing an ankle injury. He's out for this weekend as Mullally sits for 2 minutes for tripping. 2:26 left in the third period. Will Sabo stay on? Yes, he will. Gotta look for 28 in orange and gray.
You know he wants it, too. You know he wants it. So it's a matter of time.
He plays it back. Left point for Jack Graham. Over to Joey Rittenhail. Rittenhail for Sabo. And I think Illinois State is reading the play as well. They're pestering him. And they end up clearing it away. Heflin, lackadaisically, he has all day. He'll sit. Set up Jack Grant. Graham for Rittenhail. Far side pass on the tape of Novosel. Novosel, he's got Sabo in behind him. And Novosel tries to force one, and that's cleared all the way down. 37 shots for the Illini, 26 for Illinois State. Mark Hayton's done well, but Joey Garoppolo will get the loss. As Graham gains the line. Jack Graham has been impressive, and look at him. He'll fake in. Now looking around. Protects the puck well against Corcoran. Right on cue, he blows a tire in the other way. Here comes number 11, that's Glennon. Glennon shoots one, high of the glove of Heflin. A minute left in the Illini power play. Here's Novosel. Novosel at the right point, throwing it in for Sabo. Sabo surrounded by three, instead trying to get a shot off, just missed wide. When you have three Redbirds around you suppressing your chance, you can't really blame Evan Sabo for that, but he'll go off. Might be his last shift of the night. Still a solid weekend, though, for him in the fourth line. Novosel gets the goal tonight as Joe Nolan surveys his options. Just relaxing. No rush here. 28 seconds left in the power play. Here comes Nolan. His pass was knocked out. And now here's a fan effort. Now Stephen Quinn trying to get a backhand through to Wicklund. Instead, he plays it behind. Andrew Wicklund spinning. Taking off Collada. Power play almost over for Illinois. Here's Wicklund. Now across for Nolan. Nolan, backdoor play for Moskuk. Moskuk at the left circle. Wicklund looking across for Quinn. Instead, can't feed it to him. That's not open. Moskuk is, though. And he fires one in and out of the glove of Hayden. Moskuk's shot. It's so tough to defend, even if you've got a clear line of sight. Now 15 seconds left in the hockey game. Moskuk at the left circle. Collada on him again. He drops it back. Kandati winds, fires, deflected out in front. Puck is loose, cleared back to the left point. Kandati uses his hand, keep the puck in, and does. 3 seconds left. Last second ever for the Illini. Wicklund throwing it in front. That's going to conclude the hockey game. Illinois with the weekend sweep over Illinois State. They outscore the Redbirds 12-2. So 12-1 against Michigan State. 4 goals, then 8 goals. And then 5 goals and 7 goals against the Redbirds this weekend in Bloomington. An impressive showing from the offense. If you had to pick a number one star, maybe let's go to this number two star, number three star off the Illini. Which guys would you choose and why?
Eric Cookshank, just for the reason that he got 2 goals tonight. Are you saying for tonight's game or for this weekend?
Surprise me. This weekend or just tonight.
Second star, I'm going to go Joe Nolan. I've been favoring this guy all weekend. This guy's been playing phenomenal two-way hockey. And third star,
Got a lot of guys.
You know, I'm going to give it to David Heflin. Playing both games, you can't ask for much more. And he played phenomenally, only allowing 2 goals.
2 goals on 50 shots. I mean, that's just a solid effort no matter who you're playing. Over the weekend, you get 26 shots tonight and 24 last night. Nothing you could say as well as a job well done. Handshakes at the end, Illinois State saluting their crowd. 2 road wins for Illinois. They improved to 4-0 on the season, but if you're Illinois State, 0-6-2. The first thing you got to address is your power play, but even your play at even strength has to improve moving down the line.
I wouldn't even focus on power play. Like you just said, even strength is much more important because that's what you're playing at for the majority of the games. The fundamentals is what ISU needs to look back on, and mainly with puck control. They cannot be losing the puck as much as they do, and if they continue to do so, they just won't be able to generate nearly as many opportunities as they potentially could.
Eric Cruikshank leads the Illini with 3 goals this weekend. Illinois wins tonight, today. We're still in today, a Saturday matinee of hockey. We're glad you could join us here on YouTube. Illini 7, Illinois State 1. We'll have the call next week on YouTube and on WPGU 107.1 on next Friday at 7 p.m. at the Big Pond. For all of us here at Illini Hockey Broadcasting, for Abby Kelsto, Mackenzie Bach, Eric Fisher, I'm Cristiano Simonetto. We'll see you next week. Thanks for watching and enjoying this edition of Illini Hockey.